Hello, everybody. Welcome to the show tonight. Joining me to discuss the current events happening right now in Baltimore, State Senator candidate Rebecca Paddock. Also, my guest, Jamie Oot, declined to come on, so we're going to talk about what he wrote up about this whole situation. 10 things all white folks need to consider about the Baltimore uprising. We'll be talking about that. Then, later on tonight, Heather Bumpus welcomes back from the Australian Paranormal Society, Mr. William Tabone. And then later on, after all the kids are nice and tucked in and ready for school tomorrow, we'll jump in bed with Dani Blaze, and she discusses dress code. How ladies should dress.
Or not dress.
Or not dress, and why you get the attention you get, and dick pics. Do they really work? Find out. Stick around. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you... You're on the air.
World of Tank Gamers. Armed and its affiliated divisions are recruiting entire clans and tankers. Armed, the largest and most progressive gaming community on the World of Tanks gaming platform. Now on 3 servers. To join, visit www.armedtanks.net or hashtag need a toaster. Toast that, bitches.
Now, I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat. Right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen. Hi, welcome back to the show. Over my shoulder on the big screen of death in the man cave, I've got, well, I'm flipping back and forth between two of the biggest propagandists going on, Fox News and MSNBC, both are down covering the riots in Baltimore. Come to find out, the riot part of that whole thing is not even a small fraction of what's going on. And yes, businesses are still being destroyed, officers are being injured, so are civilians, but of course, the propagandists are showing us a side of it that basically isn't the whole truth. How about that? Tonight's broadcast is brought to you by e24.com. Put the app on your phone. It's free. You can download it from the iStore or the Apple or the Google Play Store. Put your zip code in there. They're going to find a restaurant somewhere near you that you can order and pay for your food over the app, and they'll deliver it to wherever you're at. So it's pretty cool. It's like having a food truck in your pants. That's e24.com. Okay, well, I always try to get quality guests for the show, and I want to get guys on here that I can talk to that don't agree with me. I tell people I am the anti-media. I am not a Republican. I'm not a Democrat. I'm really not a libertarian, even though the libertarian kind of mindset, if you want to put a label on me personally, I kind of lean towards that. But what it really boils down to is I'm tired of the media and the media outlets and the propagandists and everything else just inundating us with all these stories and information that's really designed to divide us. Now, Baltimore sucks. What's going on down there sucks. There are people that, the destroying of a CVS, the destroying of private property and private businesses, overturning police cars. What these folks don't understand is, A, it had nothing that what they're doing doesn't affect either positively or negatively anything about what happened to the young man that they're writing about. It's just an excuse to go destroy stuff. All that stuff has to be replaced at taxpayers' expense, meaning the people that are destroying it, if they live in Baltimore and pay taxes, you're basically destroying your own property. Destroying somebody's private business. Well, what you've done now is you've shut that business down, put at least 5 to 7 employees out of work, so that means they're going to have to get unemployment, plus the insurance company, of course, will be contacted. Then they have to go through the entire fight to get the insurance to rebuild the building, which means the insurance premiums will go up for the other businesses in the area, which means some businesses might not even be able to afford that, and they'll go out of business. And then it comes right back around to, well, nobody builds any shops or anything in our neighborhood. So it's really not helping anything. Well, a gentleman that I contacted on Facebook, his name is Jamie Oot. I think that's how you say his name, Jamie Oot. A fellow white man like myself, who writes for Everyday Feminism magazine. Mm-hmm. I contacted him on Facebook, and I asked him if he would like to come on the show. And his response was, I'd love to have you on my show, on the air with Mike Allen. Check out my show page for the past episodes. Email me at this email. For the details, shows airs Wednesday nights. I'd like to have listeners around the country and overseas. And he says, hi, Mike. Can you explain why specifically you'd want me on your show? What's the topic and the angle? I'm going to talk to you about your thing. Says, it was a Facebook share. The Facebook share, I believe the one where on what white people should know about race. I can't find it now, blah, blah, blah. He says, thanks for the offer, but I think I'll pass. So basically, this guy, Jamie Oot, will only go on shows that further his agenda. And what he wrote was an article called 10 Things All White Folks Need to Consider About the Baltimore Uprising. Now, remember, the actual rioting and the destruction that's going on is a very small part of what's going on there. There's actually well over 100,000 people who are peacefully protesting, who aren't beating up police, who aren't ravaging the city or anything like that. It's very well put together, and it's just not the rioting and the few knuckleheads that are running around is a very small portion of what's going on, which is not being reported by the news. But apparently it's a hashtag Baltimore Uprising. So if you go and you want to tweet us tonight, and later on we're going to be accepting phone calls, and Rebecca Paddock will be joining me in the second segment, along with our own Dani Blaze, who likes to weigh in on this. But first, let me educate everybody on this article written by Jamie Oot, 10 things all white folks need to consider about the Baltimore uprising.
Can I just say something before you read this off?
Sure, go ahead, Dani.
Okay. So I pulled this up. One, the fact that it's on a website called Everyday Feminism gives it no credibility right there. And that's coming from a woman. Most people don't even know what feminism means. That's another rant, but we'll save that for a different time. So I was reading it because obviously I'm going to chime in on this. And it just doesn't make any sense.
But I'm going to go through it right now.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to go through it. He writes, as I reflect upon the most recent Baltimore uprising taking place in the wider movement for racial justice in the United States, I can't help but be simultaneously frustrated and inspired by white people in my life. I'm inspired by white friends and mentors who are striving for accountable solidarity to black people within the Black Lives Matter movement. And I'm constantly taking notes on how I can do more to advance the cause of racial justice through my own work, words, and activism. But I'm also frustrated and disappointed in how so many of us are choosing to direct as much energy as possible to blaming people of color for their own oppression and to condemning them for the expressions of grief and rage that make us uncomfortable and afraid. So as I reflect on these simultaneous feelings, I want to reach out through the medium of my writing, one white person to another, in hopes of inspiring us to think and engage more critically as people of color literally fight for their lives. This can be found, before I read any further, on everydayfeminism.com. Again, I'm reading from 10 Things All White Folks Need to Consider About the Baltimore Uprising. Number one, as white people, we are not victims of racial oppression. There is not a statistical measure that exists by which white people are oppressed while people of color are privileged. Hasn't visited Africa much at all in his life.
If ever.
They're pretty much running everything over there. And dogs are talking. As such, we get zero say in how people are oppressed or respond to their oppression. There's a vast dialogue and debate within the black communities and other communities of color about the most effective ways to realize justice, and none of these conversations should be the voices or leadership we white people who benefit from systems of racial oppression be centered. Again, reading the article from Mr. Jamie Oot, 10 Things All White Folks Need to Consider About the Baltimore Uprising. Number two, a movement of nonviolence has been occurring. We just haven't been paying attention. So many of us call on oppressed people to act nonviolently when they are being brutalized by violent police, institutions, and systems. But people of color have been in the streets nonviolently for years, calling for an end to racist police violence. Where are we? Yes, many white folks have shown up and shown out in solidarity, but by and large, we as white people have been silent. It's entirely possible for us to believe in the transformative power of nonviolent revolution without patronizingly telling black people how they should express their anger and rage. That comes from being murdered in the streets by police. It pains me to see anger, hurt, frustration, and pain boil over into throwing of stones and destruction of property, but we need to remember the source of this pain, systematic racism expressed through police violence. We simply have no right to tell a community that lives with the brutalization of white supremacy daily how they should direct, express, and rage. Again, reading from 10 Things All White Folks Need to Consider about the Baltimore Uprising by Mr. Jamie Oot, who declined to come on the show. Number three, the destruction of property pales in comparison to the destruction of lives. So this is what gets me. A justification of destroying somebody else's business who has nothing to do with what happened to the young man, led nothing to his demise, didn't kick him, didn't punch him, didn't shoot him, nothing. Just got up in the morning, went to their jobs, opened their shops, fed their families, provided a service for that community, the community in which this young man lived, this private business owner. Why is it that we white folks seem to be 10 times more outraged by the destruction of property than by the fact that police kill black, indigenous, and Latinx, I think it's Latino people, every 19 hours in 2015? Why are we 10 times more outraged by the setting of fires and by the racist capitalist systems that produce the poverty that devastates the communities of color? We can say all we like that we are feeling for the small business owners and individuals who lost their property, but every one of those broken windows can be replaced and every burnt building can be rebuilt. And who do you think is going to... Let me keep reading. The lives of the people taken by police and consumed by our system's endless appetites for black, brown, and indigenous suffering can never be returned. Again, reading from Mr. Jamie Oot, 10 Things All White Folks Need to Consider About the Baltimore Uprising, which can be found on everydayfeminism.com, which is an interesting web page to begin with. Dr. King wasn't here for us, and he still isn't. This is number 4. Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. is not a cudgel for the white people to use against black people who respond to their oppression in ways that we do not find palatable. The Reverend Dr. King was a radical revolutionary who called for a complete overturning of the racist capitalist system in which we live. We do not get to co-opt and distort his legacy or that of any civil rights leaders to maintain the status quo. We would do well to actually read the writings of Dr. King rather than cherry-pick the quotes that support our, white people, agenda and to consider his words for white moderates.
Quick thing before we continue reading.
Go ahead.
So, wasn't he here for, like, everyone to be equal?
Yeah, that's what I got out of it.
He wasn't like, hey, black people should be, like, held high because bad things happened in history, but white people shouldn't get anything. No, he was like, shouldn't we all come together and be friends?
Exactly.
Okay.
That's, yeah.
Okay.
Number 5, stop. Seriously, stop with the hashtag All Lives Matter. When we say hashtag All Lives Matter, we are participating in the erasure of the lives who sadly do not matter within our system of oppression while injecting our own need to be centered into a movement for racial justice. Black Lives Matter is a revolutionary call for change in systems where black lives, cultures, and communities are devalued. And then he gives some links. What you mean by All Lives Matter by Ariel Newton of the Black Millennials. Please Stop Telling Me That All Lives Matter by Julia Craven of the Huffington Post. And What's Wrong with All Lives Matter by George Yancey and Judith Butler of the New York Times. Number 6 from... 10 things that all white folks need to consider about the Baltimore uprising. And I'm going to go a little long here for our first break. I'm going to get through this. Having a black president doesn't absolve us of racism. It's racist and tokenizing to point out individual black people in positions of power while ignoring vast oppression that impacts the lives of black people in an attempt to prove that racism is over. Citing that we have a black president while ignoring the ways that black people and other people of color suffer in racist education systems, justice systems, healthcare systems, and economic systems is disingenuous at best and downright racist at worst. The existence of individual black politicians or black police chief, or a black mayor, does not undo the daily oppression of black people experienced in our systems, particularly when black elected officials often toe the lines of racist oppression to stay in office. So he basically just called, the Baltimore police chief is black. Mm-hmm. The Baltimore fire chief, black. The mayor is black. Of 14 sitting council members, 9 are black. But they're all Uncle Toms, according to him. And Uncle Tom is a black man who kisses up to the whites to maintain position. This guy's a trip. I wish I would have got him on the show. If you're listening, Mr. Oot, you missed out. I tell you what, we're going to take a break. When we get back, I'm going to invite Ms. Rebecca Paddock on, and also Dani Blaze will join me in this discussion as we get in more into this article, which can be found again on everydayfeminism.com. 10 things all white folks need to consider about the Baltimore uprising. Stick around later on today. Heather Bumpus, Heather, Things That Go Bumpus in the Night, will be joining us for her segment in the paranormal, welcoming back Mr. William Tabone from the Australian Paranormal Society. And then in the last hour, after kids are all tucked into bed, we're going to jump in bed with Dani Blaze. She talks about what to wear, what not to wear, why people wear things, and if you wear something, guys are going to react. Oh, and how important is that dick pic? Stick around.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Attention, world of tank gamers. Armed and its affiliated divisions are recruiting entire clans and tankers. Armed, the largest and most progressive gaming community on the World of Tanks gaming platform. Now on three servers. To join, visit www.armedtanks.net or hashtag need a toaster. Toast that, bitches. Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern. Spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spring. Exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
All right, welcome back to the show. Joining us now on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, senatorial candidate for the Libertarian Party in the last election, Miss Rebecca Paddock. How you doing, ma'am?
Great. How are you doing, Mike?
I'm doing absolutely fantastic. You've been listening to this article that I'm reading?
I have been listening.
Okay, we're on number... Where was I here?
Number seven.
Number seven. It says, silence is violence. No matter how wonderful our intentions or how good we may be in our daily lives, if we are silent in the face of racial injustice, we are complicit to its violence. Worse, when we actively try to police the actions of those people of color who are fighting for their freedom, we are committing subtle yet clear acts of racial violence. Number eight, being a race traitor isn't a thing. It's called humanity. To stand against the systems of oppression that afford us privilege does not inherently mean that we self-hate or white guilt. That's funny, because that's kind of what I'm getting out of this whole article up to this point. To stand against injustice means that we are choosing to get in touch with our own humanity and to divest in the systems of whiteness while still working our own flawed and complicated ways to invest in justice and anti-racist ways of being in the world as white people.
This doesn't make sense anymore.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Again, we're reading from my guest who backed out tonight, Jamie Oot. 10 things all white folks need to consider about the Baltimore uprising. He declined to come on the show. So I'm reading his article. Number 9, instead of investing in whiteness, invest in the movement. If we are willing to listen, show up and follow the black, brown, and indigenous leadership of this movement, we can find incredible community filled with great love, accountability, and loyalty. Whiteness attempts to isolate us, to make us invest in our own access to oppressive systems rather than in community and people. But there are alternatives to investing in whiteness, and one of the most important alternatives is the community found in building trust across difference while fighting for justice under diverse leadership. And then number 10, use your time and energy to call other white people. Our voice, energy, and labor is needed in calling in white people, our people, to change. In doing so, you must act in ways that are accountable to people of color and that draw upon the history of white resistance to white supremacy. If we are simply going to defend the status quo, then we need to sit down and be quiet. But if we're going to work with our people to inspire more white folks to accountability, work for justice, then our role is clear. And it is our responsibility to rise to that role and speak out for justice. Now, I heard a lot of justice. I've heard a lot of, basically, it's all our fault. That's kind of what I'm getting out of this. Am I wrong here? Rebecca?
Well, I'm confused.
As I.
So, wasn't like one of the first points he made was that if you happen to be white, then you don't have a nickel in this quarter and you don't have an opinion?
Pretty much.
Then can you explain to me why he continued typing after that?
Well,
because isn't he white?
He's white. He's a white dude.
And he just got done saying that if you're white, you have no nickel in this quarter.
Pretty
then
much.
If that's the case, his article should have stopped there. Let's start with that. Number two, this guy is male. Is that correct?
Yes.
And the name of the blog, the name of the place?
Everyday Feminism.
Feminism. So if you're white and you have no nickel in the quarter, then wouldn't it be that if you're male, then you have no nickel in the feminism quarter?
Boom.
Pretty much. Yeah.
So I'm just very confused by all this hypocrisy.
Well, one of the things I take away from this is basically whites have everything, but there per capita, there are more white men or white families living in poverty and more white families on food stamps than black families per capita.
There are also more white people shot by police every year than black people.
Well, and I had that discussion, but what people like to do is they like to bring up the fact that they're blacks only constitute about 1/4 of our total citizenry. So percentage-wise, more blacks get killed than whites. Percentage-wise.
You also don't see a bunch of white people rioting for no reason.
Well, yeah, we do. Anytime a Canadian hockey team wins, they riot.
But that's fair. That's for sports.
Well, that's a problem, too. I mean, rioting is rioting. I don't care what the reason is.
Kentucky basketball team lost their game, and they pretty much burned down the campus. But
which, I mean, it's rioting. I don't care who's doing it. It doesn't matter.
That's wrong,
what color
of course.
You are.
It doesn't matter.
If you are out there destroying property and hurting people, you're rioting.
Well, here's my question. This is a question I have. What role in the death of this young man in the hands of police, which we're still finding out information on, we haven't got the full story yet, what role did the 66-inch LED big screen TV that went out through the window of that store that was getting looted have in the oppression of that young man?
Well, it was obviously its fault.
Because it had to be saved, apparently, from the capitalist store.
You know,
where it was stored. I mean, I don't get this.
Here's the deal. This is what we know. We know that the guy died while he was in police custody. That we know.
Yeah.
Do we know why he died?
They said his spine was severed. Or he had a severed spine, and that's what led to his demise.
Okay. So did the police do that?
See, that's the thing.
Did the police know about it?
Let's
take it out of all this for a second, shall
well,
we?
Well, here's what's being reported. Uh-huh. What's being reported is that the gentleman ran, mm-hmm. was captured by police, and there's mm-hmm. video of the police roughing him up a little bit, and they threw him in the back of a van, and then sometime while he was in police custody, allegedly, he suffered a severed spine and two broken legs, and that he was transported to the hospital where he passed away.
Okay.
And that's been reported on both Fox, because I watched both of them to kind of get them. I learned this from being a cop. You get the left side, you get the right side, and somewhere in the middle is the thing. But now is the truth. But now they're coming out with more information saying that he already had a bad back, that he had just got done having back surgery, which why is he out breaking the law if he's already had back surgery? And there's eyewitness report that's being suppressed by a couple of the news media outlets, but it's being reported by Fox News that a witness that was in the van with this gentleman basically is saying that he was throwing himself around in the van because he was upset.
So he had, wait a minute, he had back surgery?
That's the report. That's the report that they're trying to, I've heard it from a couple of different sources, and I think they're trying to find out if that's the case, that he actually had back surgery for a pre-existing injury from an injury he sustained running from police and got into a car crash and got a bad back. He was fleeing police in a car. So all around great guy. I mean, I'm not trying to talk ill about the dead, but, you know, if I jump off a roof into a swimming pool, chances are I'm going to get wet.
So here's the deal. I'm going to make an analogy here, right? And obviously this is not neither one of these two are what happened. But let's say for the sake of argument, he had a heart attack or an aneurysm in police custody.
Mm-hmm.
That happens. Hey, I was at work and we had a 25-year-old drop dead of a heart attack at his desk. The company held no liability or culpability for it. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And the company wouldn't have any culpability with an aneurysm either. Now, if he was diabetic and the police knew he was diabetic, and he went into a diabetic coma and died as a result of that. That would maybe show some police negligence, right?
Yeah.
So
that would make sense.
So those are like the two extremes. Now this guy is out. I don't know what kind of surgery he had.
Well, again, that's a report that came across today and yesterday actually when I was researching this and talking to Mr. Oot to come on the show. And it was a kind of a breaking news on the internet, and then they touched on it on MSNBC. I believe it was MSNBC. It might have been CNN, where he was actually hurt before the police got a hold of him.
Okay, and then did he ever tell the police, I've had surgery, be careful with me?
Oh, I don't know. Again, that's all part of the investigation that's happening right now. The video, the video that shows the police officers taking him into custody, though, you know, they're roughing him up and kicking him and everything else. So,
well, that shouldn't be going on.
Of course not.
But here's the deal.
But what does the houses and the businesses have to do with what the police did to this young man?
Rioting is unacceptable. Okay? It's unacceptable. It's illegal. There are better ways to get the message across. You know, MLK and Gandhi and our founding fathers and anybody else that was involved in making real change is rolling over in their grave right now. I mean, instead of focusing on fixing the root cause of the problem, finding the root cause of the problem,
and finding what happened,
and fixing the root cause of the problem, we're talking about rioting. You know, there are people out there protesting, real protesters out there protesting, and the message isn't about protesting. The message is about rioting. How is that helping?
If you would like to be part of the conversation with myself and Rebecca, you can give us a call at 1-866-225-5401 or 512-539-0357. Or you can tweet me at MikeAllen_OTA if you'd like to chime in. Now, here's my question. I keep hearing systematic oppression. I keep hearing a system of racial oppression. I keep hearing all this stuff, right? And here's some facts. The mayor, police chief, and fire chief, and a majority of the leadership in the police department are all black. Of the 14 sitting council members in Baltimore, of the 14 sitting council members, 9 are black. So these are the folks that are in the positions of leadership in the city of Baltimore. The city manager is black. The mayor is black and female. So where is the oppression in Baltimore coming from if all the leadership in Baltimore is black? And that's what I wanted to ask Mr. Oot. How is it possible that Baltimore has a systematic system of oppression? And I'm looking at the TV right now. It's showing a bunch of officers lined up in Baltimore. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are on the TV, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 are black. So 7 out of the 9 riot police in Baltimore are black. So where's the oppression coming from then if the entire leadership of a major city and a majority of the police force is black? That's my question.
Well, you know, I don't understand why people are so focused on putting grievances on the color of their skin, their gender, their sexual orientation, yada, yada, yada. Are there racists out there? Yeah, probably there are.
But racism is an individual thing.
Yeah.
All right, stick around, Rebecca. We're going to come back and talk more with Ms. Rebecca Paddock. You can be a part of the conversation. 1-866-225-5401, 512-539-0357. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by e24.com. Stick around. We'll be right back. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air.
Is your wife wicked, hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you'll need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
I got Fox News going on over the shoulder here. Well, welcome back to the show. You're listening to On the Air with Mike Allen on Armed Radio Global. We're on every Wednesday night starting at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time. You can go to ontheairwithmikeallen.com for show updates and information about the cast and what we're doing here at Armed Radio. And also see any upcoming shows that we have when the guests show up. You can call in today, 1-866-225-5401, or you can tweet at Mike Allen underscore OTA, hashtag it Armed Radio. That way it'll show up on my tweet deck. I don't have to go looking for it. Right now, we return on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline. Political candidate for the Texas Senate last year for the Libertarian Party ran against John Cornyn. Had a very good showing. Ms. Rebecca Paddock, welcome back.
Thank you.
All right. Now, during the break, Dani actually and I were talking and before she got distracted because another sexy beard walked into the room.
Sometimes when you talk, I just want to punch you in the face.
But I have a beard, so it'll just deflect. What were we talking about? What was it that we were saying?
I honestly forgot.
See, I forgot too.
So I said.
So we'll move on. It was off the air.
Racist people probably do exist.
Well, they do exist.
Bigoted people exist.
Of course they do.
But in order for somebody to say it's systemic, that's not just a claim that you can make. So where are the facts and data that support a systemic effect?
And plus, there's too many people of color and people of different religious affiliations and everything that have been successful. I think it's a personal choice, to be quite honest with you. You personally choose to be successful. You personally choose to be whatever it is you want to be. And if you allow somebody to tell you you can't do something because of race or because of a religion or gender, then, you know, you deserve everything you get, in my opinion. But to say that, you know, that the police department of Baltimore, and I just looked it up, which is over half is African American and Latino, as opposed to white, that's being led by a black man, that's being led, that has commanders and sergeants who are black, that police department is systematically going after the black citizens of Baltimore is not only ludicrous, there's nothing to back it up. I mean, there's zero to back it up, to be quite honest with you.
Well, we've had this discussion before, Mike, and one of the problems that I see with the society, the American society right now, is we are a society of victims. And instead of people taking responsibility and accountability for their own life and their own decisions and moving forward with that, we blame it on other people. And I have to tell you, I'm not perfect, right? I'm not perfect. And I can tell you there are hundreds of reasons that you could not like me besides the fact that I'm white or female or have medical issues. There are hundreds of reasons you could not like me besides those. So blaming somebody not liking me on me being female is preposterous. So anybody just automatically assuming that they're not liked because they're male or they're female or they're black or they're white or they happen to be wearing the color red, you know, where did you come up with this in your head? It has never made any sense to me. So I don't understand it. That's just something I don't understand.
Well, you know, I grew up in northern Michigan. There wasn't a whole lot of diversity up in northern Michigan because, quite frankly, only crazy Polacks and Germans lived that far north because it was so freaking cold. So we didn't have a huge diversity of folks. It was mostly, again, German, Norwegian, and Polish immigrants that moved up there. So when I joined the military and spent 10 years in the Army, it was overwhelmingly black. I was in the field artillery, and I had never been in a unit where the white soldiers were a minority. And you know what difference that made in my career?
Zero.
None. Because we're all in the same unit. We're all in the Army. Even when we went to battle, it never came up that, you know, I'm out here serving with African Americans, with Puerto Ricans, with Mexicans, with Germans, with this and that. It never came up. And then when I became a police officer, and one of the big metropolises down here, Austin, I worked in a predominantly black neighborhood. Do you know how many times I heard racial profiling and racism and bigotry and stuff like that as a police officer from the people I worked with, the people I dealt with in Austin?
I have no idea.
Never. Never.
There you have it.
They were gangbangers, and they sold drugs. They knew that. I knew that. They knew that I knew that they knew that I knew that. And there was none of this prejudice. You know, I pulled somebody over for standing on the corner of 16th and Paquito, looking all shady at 3 o'clock in the morning, wearing all red from head to toe. And the first thing out of his mouth is, "You're racially profiling me." Well, no kidding, I'm racially profiling you. You're sitting there selling drugs. And you're in the O2 Bloods. You know who had the bigger problem with it?
Who?
The press. And the people outside the arena, looking in, looking for a reason to complain about stuff, looking for a reason to complain. Matter of fact, one of the biggest weapons that those folks that we were dealing with, one of the biggest weapons they had against us was just the threat of filing a complaint and making it public, even if it was totally bogus. That's why I ran my camera. Man, if I had a contact with anybody for anything, I had my camera on. And I turned it on and kept it on. And if I'd have had a body camera, that would even be better. We didn't have body cameras back then. We just had the car cameras. So they didn't work up to the audio didn't work. I think it worked up to like 25 feet from the car. And then the audio cut out. So, but I kept that thing running. I got my first complaint of that I used the N-word with somebody I was dealing with. And it was, of course, not true. And thank God I turned my camera on because I gave my tape over to my sergeant and they investigated. And meanwhile, I'm home, sitting at home, chilling out under administrative leave. And I'm glad that didn't hit the papers. But they were trying to get it to hit the papers that this new class, I was a rookie, this new class that came out from the academy, they're all racist. And I was, you know, of course, absolved of that complaint. But everybody that was in the arena, that the drug dealers, the people that we were chasing down and everything like that, never did that come up race. Never did race come up as a motivation. They knew what they were doing. They knew what we had to do. We both had our jobs, and we did them.
I don't understand. You know, I don't understand this. I do not understand why people think it's okay to go out and loot and destroy and harm people. You know, that's your message is lost. If you were protesting police brutality, guess what? Police brutality has not been on the news. What's been on the news is rioting. You lost your message.
Well, I don't think
advertising would say that's a failed marketing campaign.
And I think the people that are out there protesting right now, and well, the people that are rioting, not the protesters, which isn't being covered, but there hasn't been any violence at all. They came in and are taking advantage of a situation to get free stuff. I mean, like I asked Danny earlier, I mean, what did that 65-inch LED TV do to you to where you need to take it out of the store it was sitting in because of this kid, you know, because of whatever reason you thought of?
Well, the truth of the matter is, it's not free. There is a cost. I don't know if there even is such a thing as rioting insurance for businesses. I would guess there's probably not.
Well, we were discussing that, too, about how insurance premiums for these businesses in this community now are going to go up because of the insurance is going to have to fix businesses that were destroyed. And then
I don't know. Do we know that's a fact?
I don't even know. If the insurance doesn't cover it, they just lost their store.
Well, exactly. Exactly, which is probably, you know, it's not great for CVS because they're a chain, right? It's not great.
Well, that's just one store. There's been other stores too that have been.
But what about the mom and pop store?
Yeah, well, even with CVS, look at all the people out of work now.
There are a lot of people. There are a lot of people.
You know, all the people that worked in that CVS have no place to work.
CVS will recover. They may never put another store in there, but CVS isn't going out of business because one store went down.
Yeah.
Mom and pop stores, how are they going to recover? They're done.
Well, exactly.
You just destroyed some people's livelihoods.
Well, Rebecca, it is always a pleasure to come on. What's your next endeavor here? Are you going to make another run at Congress in another couple of years, or are you going to go local, or what?
I'm taking a look at running for the U.S. Senate again. We'll see. I haven't made a decision.
Against John? Well, you had a good show. I mean, quarter of the vote. That's pretty good.
I had a good showing. We broke some records, which was nice. The party enjoyed that. It's going to take some work, but it's going to take some work. It's going to take some time. And we'll see how things go.
Okay.
In the meantime, you know, it's a matter of continuing to try and be the voice of reason.
Well, it was a pleasure to have you on. Came in in the last minute. Came in the clutch. And you're always welcome on the show. Always welcome on the show. You bet. We're trying to get Patrick McClear on the show.
He's a sweetheart.
Talk about his puppies. Man, did you see those puppies? Jesus.
He's a sweetheart.
Yeah, he's a good guy. All right, Rebecca, thank you so much for coming on.
Thanks. Have a great evening, Mike.
You bet. You too. As Ms. Rebecca Paddock, she is a political candidate for the United States Senate from the great state of Texas, ran against John Cornyn last year, had a great showing. Of course, I'm going to go ahead and extend my invitation out to Mr. Oot again, if he'd like to come on and discuss what I've discussed about his writing. I'd love to have him on. So if anybody out there is listening and you have connections with him or anybody at Everyday Feminism Magazine, the online blog magazine, tell them they're welcome on the show. And we'll talk about whatever you want to talk about. Well, when we get back, Miss Heather Bumpus will be joining us. And she has Mr. William Tabone from the Australian Paranormal Society. So stick around. Then later on, we get in bed with Miss Dani Blaze as she talks about clothes. And if you don't want guys to go after you, maybe dress a little like an Amish person, I guess. I don't know. Anyway. And dick pics, do they work? She'll answer that question. We'll be back after these messages. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network. And you are on the air.
Is your wife wicked, hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
All right, welcome back to the show. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by E24.com. It just yes on your phone to find out where you are, and it'll find a restaurant to bring food right to you. Let's say you're in a business meeting. You're out of town. Nobody knows where anything's at. You're sitting in these long seminars. Lunch is coming up. You only have an hour. to try to get a cab, get around, go find some place, stand in line, get something to eat. While everybody else is fretting about it and trying to figure it out, all you have to do is open up your eat24.com app, put in your zip code, it'll find you, it'll find a restaurant, and when everybody's running out to go to lunch, your food will be running in. That's eat24.com. I'm trying to find our guest over here. Thought I saved him. Oh, I just got banned from the feminist webpage.
That webpage is so stupid. Some of the articles I was reading on there,
funny.
I was like,
only Mike Allen.
It says content no longer available. IP address has been banned. That's awesome. Somebody was listening. I'm so cool. That's so cool.
Am I supposed to
I don't know if William's on here anymore. I see Wayne. William Tabone, there he is. All right, welcome to this segment of the show, Miss Heather, Things That Go Bumpus in the Night.
Hello. Hello, hello.
So we're going to try to get William on here or what?
He said that he's going to call in.
I'm going to call him. He's waiting on my call. So you ready?
Well, excuse me.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Are you ready? The question is, are you ready?
I am ready.
She's going to store all this stuff up next time she gets hold of some vodka. I'm in trouble.
We're a tag team.
I'm done with the vodka. Thank you.
God, you tore my ass up.
I'm sorry.
It's on the Ring Central Celebrity. You want me to write this down?
What? Hey, William.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Yeah, good, Mike. Good. You?
Pretty good. Hey. Okay, so before we, like, even get started, you know, last week you were going to be on and something came up. You couldn't make it. And you said you had a surprise, and it has been driving me insane. What is going on?
I'm coming to Texas in September.
Awesome!
We're going to have some barbecue.
Yay!
We are going to barbecue.
Are you coming for an investigation?
I'm going Gettysburg with Brad Clinch.
Uh-huh.
And then before that, I'm going to Eastern State Penitentiary. And before that, I'm going to go up to Ellis Island. Then I'm going to come across there for, I'll have 2 days there.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm heading up to New Orleans. And then I'll be back for another couple of days. So
we want to go.
Okay, yeah. So where's my invite here? I mean, come on.
Tag along.
I would love to tag along. My goodness.
Now we're talking to Mr. William Tabone. He's from the Australian Paranormal Society.
Yes.
And the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline.
Yes. Now, I do have a question for you.
Yes.
I have been watching the new show out of Australia, The Haunting Australia. And have you seen it?
Oh, is it that Haunting Australia? Haunting Australia?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, I've seen it.
Okay,
yes.
Now,
yeah.
I've been recording
it's, okay.
Go ahead.
Sorry?
No, go ahead.
No, you go ahead. No, I was just going to say, yeah, I've seen it. Yep.
Okay.
Definitely.
Okay, yeah, okay. I've been recording it and watching it. Now, some of the places that they have been investigating, have you been to those places?
Yeah, the ones down in Victoria, Airedale and the Geelong Jail, etc. But I don't think they went to Beechworth. Asylum. Airedale is an asylum. It was one of the big. It was the biggest in the Southern Hemisphere at its time. It still has 63 buildings that you can go and investigate. And Geelong Jail. So yes, I've investigated them extensively. Yeah, definitely.
That is awesome. I mean, it was really cool to watch it and actually, you know, see the buildings, and it's all the buildings I see out there are beautiful. Yep. I mean, just, you know, and I was watching the one where it was the, I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but the Adelaide Arcade.
Yep, another one. That's down with, that's in South Australia.
Oh.
Yep. If you watch the Airedale one, I'm actually in that.
Are you?
I'm the, because I've investigated it so often, and so extensively, they got me basically into, to answer some questions, talk about it a little bit. So yeah, it was good fun.
Oh
yeah.
So see, I feel special. I know someone famous.
Not that famous.
Hey, famous enough for them to want to interview you and put you on TV.
Well, hey, look, they must have been desperate now, money.
No, that's pretty cool.
It was interesting, yes.
Well, I actually have that one recorded, so I'll have to watch it.
You'll have to watch it, yeah. See my head on there.
and point you out.
That's it.
So have you, obviously, well, you just told us that you're getting ready to do a big kind of cross-country state investigation.
That's up in September. So what we're doing is, as I said, I'm gonna fly across. I'm going to go to New York, spend a couple of days in New York and have a look at, a few of the places there.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm going to come down to Philadelphia and meet up with a good friend of mine, a good investigator called Grayson Smith. He does Real Paranormal TV, it's called. And I saw him last time I was there, but very, very briefly, but I'm hoping to spend a bit more time with him. Mm-hmm. And do Eastern States Penitentiary and a few other places there. Then shoot across and meet Brad Clinge in Baltimore. And then over to Gettysburg to do an event there, an investigation event there for about four days. Then we're going to have a quick look at a few other places before we head back to San Antonio there.
That is awesome. I'm hoping to meet up with you. I mean, it would be great to meet you in person and you know, maybe if it's a Wednesday or, you know, I don't know what your dates are, we could actually have you in the studio.
Well, I'm still working out dates, but I'm hoping to be able to be there on a Wednesday night so that I could just come in and see you guys at least. You know, I'll at least catch up with you at some time.
That would be amazing.
There will be much flesh burned on a grill if you make it out here to the studio. And we will eat heartily.
Yes, Mike. Sorry. You promised me that last time too, so I'm gonna hold you to that.
Hey, when you come to Texas, you gotta eat.
Yeah, so definitely.
Yeah, you gotta eat.
You gotta eat Bumpus.
Yes.
Yeah, we got ribs. We got steaks. We gotta eat sausages. Yeah, gotta eat.
I'm
hungry now.
So then, your next surprise is you're bringing me out to Australia, right?
I can get us cheap flights.
Did we lose you?
William, still there?
Yes, you there? Can you hear me? Oh,
okay.
Hello?
Yep, we're still there.
Sorry. Yeah, the internet. I think the internet's playing up around here at the moment.
I think he just was acting like he didn't hear me when I said your next surprise is that you're inviting me and bringing me to Australia.
I heard you. I told you I was going to put you in the suitcase and bring you back with me.
Awesome. There you go. I'm all for that. I'll fit in your suitcase.
Yeah, you know, I'm all for broadcasting from down under too. The international show. You know, we could just
head on down. Awesome. You guys should come over here. Then we can look after you.
Absolutely. All I need is a big can of Foster's and something to eat.
And we do good barbecue as well, mate, so you'll enjoy that.
What would we eat? Kangaroo?
We'll kill your tiger snake or something.
A tiger snake?
Hey, man, awesome. That's what I'm talking about.
What? Is a tiger snake? Is it a real snake?
It's a real snake. I'm only joking with you. It's a very aggressive, poisonous snake that we have here. But no, we do barbecue. I actually got my father-in-law and my brother-in-law are both butchers, so I get the good stuff.
Okay, but you just said it's like really poisonous. So are you trying to poison us or what?
No, I'm only joking with you. I've got, as I said, my father-in-law and my brother-in-law are both butchers, so I make sure I get the really good stuff for you.
Oh, okay. Well, then that's fair.
Yeah, that's it. So we'll have to get you over here to have one of our barbecues.
Awesome, absolutely.
That's a deal.
So have you done any recent investigations since we've talked?
We had an event just the about 2 weeks ago. We had a premiere of a TV show that we were part of, another one, which is called In Tenebris, which means in the darkness. And a friend of mine who's a documentary maker investigator up in Sydney does these sort of series. We had that at an old historic village where we'd done an investigation afterwards and took some people around. And that was very interesting. We had some good stuff there. Yeah.
Well, is it a show or something that we could actually see here, or is it just strictly local?
I'm still uncertain where it's going to be shown, okay. But I will let you know. But if you look it up on the internet, it's called In, which, you know, I-N, Tenebris, T-E-N-E-B-R-I-S, I think it is, In Tenebris.
Okay.
From Moonlark Media.
Okay, I'll definitely look that up.
And, yeah, they'll have more on there, but they're filming all the time. They're great people. And, yeah, we had a really good event where we went out and investigated this old historic village. And we've done a few little investigations around. We've been busy organising other things as well. We have Ben Hansen coming over here from Fact of Fate. And we've got Chad Kelly coming as well.
Wow.
So we've got a few things we're running around organising for for the organizers.
That's awesome. You need to send them my way too.
Yeah, we'll tell them to give you guys a call.
that would be awesome. I mean, even just to talk to them, or maybe get them out here and do an investigation with us. I mean, that would be awesome.
I mean, I can give them your contacts there and say these are good people. Give them a call.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
That'd be awesome.
Definitely.
So go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Well, I was going to ask you, we've been discussing a few things about our investigations on the proper equipment. And I know we've talked to you about this before, but we heard that, having an actual tape recorder with us in a 35 millimeter, not a digital camera, but, like a film camera. Are those the best things to have, do you think?
Well, they're different. They're another part of the investigation. So if you have your digital equipment, your digital recorders, your digital cameras, etc. Mm-hmm. But then if you use 35 mil film, or you use a cassette recorder or cassette player to record, it gives you a different level. You're recording and capturing evidence at a different frequency, a different level. So if you can capture them in both formats, you can capture something in both formats. That's really good.
Because of the magnetic tape on the recording devices, isn't that better for capturing spirit, which is basically a magnetic type entity?
Exactly. There's a theory called the stone tape theory, which is people believe. Some people believe that certain stones they have a iron content to them, and rusty sort of content, and that sometimes emotions and energy are captured in those rocks, similar to you would a tape recorder.
Mm-hmm.
And when the environment's right, that you get those playbacks. So you'll see a scene, or you'll see a figure, or you'll see something. So yeah, it gives you that extra bit layer of evidence.
Do you carry stones with you when you guys do investigations?
Do I carry what, sorry?
Do you carry stones with you, like certain types of stones?
People do have their own. My team have their own. We use what we call grounding techniques before we go in, during and after an investigation to protect ourselves. Different people, different religions, so they do their own thing as well. Plus, they can carry whatever they feel will give them protection. Stones like black tourmaline, black obsidian, they're good protections. They absorb the negativity and give you a bit of protection from darker things.
Mm-hmm.
But it's what you believe in. I would say if you believe in Mickey Mouse will protect you, Mickey Mouse will protect you. You know what I mean?
Now, where do you find these stones at?
Well, we've got stores that we can go to and get them. There's actually it's out of the city, and it actually sells all fossils and gemstones, and it's a big factory.
Oh,
and
okay.
They're fairly reasonably priced, so we usually get our stuff from there. So
okay. Well, hey, when you come here to Texas, I have one favor.
Yeah.
You have to bring me a shot glass. I collect them, and I don't have one from Australia.
I will make sure I bring you a really good one.
And a beer mug. Beer mug for me.
And a mug?
A beer
coffee
mug.
Coffee mug?
No, beer mug.
Beer mug, yes, okay, good. I've got a beer mug for you already, mate. My father was brewing foreman for Carlton United Breweries, the ones that make... And I've got I've got boxed mugs.
Oh, wow.
Beer mugs already put away for it. So,
that is awesome.
There you go, brother.
That's amazing. That's awesome. Yay.
And they're rare ones, too. You won't find them in the shops, man. So definitely.
Well, good deal.
Definitely. That's September. And I'll let you know more dates and things when I have them properly.
Yeah, I'm very excited. Yay.
Good deal. Well, thanks for joining us again. We want to get you on more. We got to figure out a better connection here. I think it's...
Yeah. I actually had to head out somewhere else. So I'm actually on my laptop at the moment. So the sound... I might be in a bad spot. I'll have to hunt around for a better signal.
Well, good deal. Well, we're talking to William Tabone of the Australian Paranormal Society on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline. It's always a pleasure to have you on. And again, if you come to Texas and we find out that you didn't look us up or contact us or coming over, we will hunt you down, sir.
I promise you, I will hunt you both down.
Good deal. Awesome. Good
Looking
stuff.
Forward to it.
You take care, guys.
All right, thank you.
All right, thank you, William.
All right, speak again soon.
All right, bye.
Bye.
Man, that'd be cool going to Australia.
Yeah, it would.
I'm totally down for that.
I'm really excited that he's coming. He has a lot of connections, and he's a really down-to-earth guy. And, you know, I'm really excited about that.
I am, too, because that means that we can go actually do it correctly.
Yeah, take him with us. And he said that he said that he was trying to come on a Wednesday so that he could actually come for the show. So
we got a whole studio full of shenanigans going on here.
Everything's behind me, so I don't know what's going on.
Mad Mike's not here.
Yeah.
Aaron's here. What was that? What was the nickname we gave you?
DJ
Badosi?
Badissi.
DJ Badissi is here. Jerry's here, and he's got an awesome... Did you ride your bike?
Yes, and I'm sorry, but I took a picture of it because it's very awesome.
He's got the smoking Harley Davidson out in the driveway making my house look good.
Yeah, and you know what's really cool is my brother-in-law and my sister, they actually used to own a Harley shop out in Orlando, Florida. They sold it like a couple of years ago, but they have Harleys and stuff. So
and didn't get one for half price or anything.
Who, me?
Yeah, for Johnny. Johnny doesn't ride, does he?
He would.
I mean, but does he ride?
No. I think it'd look kind of hot.
It's not like getting in a car.
I think he'd kind of look pretty hot on a bike.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah.
Well, he'll have to get one. He'll have to get one, and I'll get mine. And
go riding.
Jerry, I got to do the Sturgis run. I'm talking about getting on a bike and riding up there, not doing this, putting on a trailer like a dentist and parking in my mobile home. All right, well, we'll be back with more Heather Bumpus and things that go Bumpus in the night. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
All right, welcome back to the show. Please welcome back our paranormal expert here on the air with Mike Allen. Tonight's broadcast is brought to you by E24.com. You know how to do it. What?
What is this music? Swing it, swing it,
swing it, not swing it, swing it, swing it. She was a guest on my show. She's like steampunk.
Okay. Hello? Is this thing on?
No, the mic's not on yet. Why are you beating up my mic?
That is
yeah, you beat on me, okay, you beat on my mic.
Yet. We can't talk about
jeez, here we go. Miss Heather, things that go bumpus in the night.
Can we come up with something new?
I like that.
let's do a studio survey right now.
Okay.
No.
How many people like Heather, things that go bumpus in the night?
Oh.
How many people? That 4-1.
All right. I'll stick with it. It's me. So, everybody obviously heard that we have a guest that we, you know, a friend that we met from Australia, and he's going to come out here. And, yeah, and hopefully we can get him in and do an investigation with him, and you know, it's pretty cool what he was talking about, all the places he's going to go and do all those investigations. I'd love to go.
Oh, hell yeah.
And you know what? I'm going to actually talk to him and see, like, you know, if he's somewhere close where it's kind of road trip, you know, worthy, then maybe we can go and meet up with him and get in there with him, you know?
Well, we have two minivans, so.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
Or we know a lady that works for an airline.
Airline, yeah, we have somebody.
Fly.
Yeah, we know somebody that's in with the airlines.
Yeah. So we could just fly.
We could demand first class.
They kick us out of there.
I want first class now.
They kick us out of there.
Those overpaid people, I'm telling you. I can't
understand. I cannot fly unless it's first class.
Well, then maybe you should have booked it for.
And I know a lot of our listeners, a couple of them sent me a message asking me when we were going to go on an investigation. I promise we're going to go on one soon. We have I have a lot going on, so I can't really stray from home that much. But
it's not like you're on house arrest.
I know, right? No, I'm not on house arrest.
You can only go so far with the ankle bracelet. Yeah. And then you have to return back.
But, I mean, we mentioned it last week. My father-in-law, he's very ill, so I've been taking, you know, back and forth with him. So once that kind of settles down, we'll be able to get out there and get another investigation in there.
Well, I'm still trying to get into that hotel. I've left three messages with the numbers that were given to me by the city of Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
And haven't gotten a call back on either one. I'm going to call back. Of course, I've been busy this whole week. This has been my run. So now that that's done and I got tomorrow off, I can see if I can get an email address or something like that. And see if we can go in and do some.
There is another place that I found out over there. And I actually got the number for that. So I'm going to call that. And it's pretty cool. It used to be a nursing home, but I think before that it was an actual hospital, real small. But when you're driving by, it's closed down, completely shut down. But when you drive by, there's like these two buildings, and right in the middle, there's a little cemetery.
Where, and this is in Taylor?
Yes.
What's it called?
Oh, I have it written down at home. I'll have to look it up. I'll let you
where
know.
Where is it at?
It is, you know where the Sonic is? On 95 by the Walgreens. There's a Walgreens and a Sonic.
Yes.
Okay, it's down. If you make that right by the Walgreens, go down that road, and it's right down there on the right-hand side.
Well, let's see if we can find it in Google Maps.
It's like Taylor Care or something. I forget what the name of it is now.
You said 6 weeks? Taylor Care?
I think something like that.
See if I can open Google Earth without screwing up my internet too much here.
But it's actually over by my father-in-law's house, so I see it. I've been seeing it, like, you know.
And it's just a little one-story place, or what?
It's one story, but it's like two buildings. To look it up.
Well, I got to get in touch with the guy that owns the sanitarium and get his key back. I still have his key sitting over here.
Well, I mean, we should go back in there again.
You want to go back in there?
Yeah, I think we should go back in there again. Danny's saying no, but...
You want to go with us?
She could be our guard.
Aaron?
Sure, when?
Want to go with us? He's important. See, now you got to go.
I ain't got to do shit.
we'll plan it. It'll probably be a couple weeks.
I'll go, but I won't go on that road.
Yeah, it should be fine.
And usually we'll do it on a week night or a weekend night.
Yeah, trust me, I have plenty of free time nowadays. So
as long as I go on that road, you can't run from the ghost.
I'll go into the girls' restroom this time, but I won't go back in that room.
Right. No, and I won't. Like, no, you don't need to. Our friend William that we were talking to, he was talking about a show that his buddy, you know, is doing it over in Australia, and I actually found it. It's Access Paranormal Investigations, and then that word Intenebris, and it means in the darkness. So if you Google it, you could find it. So I think that's pretty cool. And everybody heard that I've been watching that new show, Haunting Australia, and he's actually in an episode, and I didn't know that. So I have it recorded at home. I'll have to go check it out and see if I can find him on there.
Okay, so I got a map of Taylor.
Okay.
And like you said,
it's that road, and it's right down from my father-in-law, and I don't even know the road. I'm trying to find Sonic.
Where's Sonic?
It's on 95.
I know it's on 95, okay. But is it by the... I'm trying to look for it.
You know where that park is?
Yes.
When you're coming to Taylor?
Yes.
It's that road. So if you keep going straight across 95.
So it's Westlake Drive.
Yes.
And you take a...
No. Well...
There's the Sonic. Okay, so it's the road on Westlake Drive.
It's going to be behind.
It's going to go east?
It's going to be behind the Sonic and in Walgreens. Like down that road.
Ah, there it is.
Did you find it? What's the name of it?
Well, there's the Sonic.
Okay, keep going back behind it.
There's the Walgreens. Okay, so I'm going to go east on,
yeah,
on Lake Drive.
Yeah, go down
okay.
that road. And it sits on the right-hand side.
Is it this right here? Look at this.
Hold on. I'm coming around. I don't want to
run Gimp?
Yeah, no, I don't want to injure him.
Okay. The Gimpster. Is it this, is this right here?
Yeah, why is everyone here Gimpy?
Can I be nicknamed?
There's the Sonic. There's the Walgreens.
Yes, that's it. Right there.
That's it right there.
Yeah, because there's my father-in-law's place.
Okay, so it's right next to your father-in-law's place.
Yes.
And that's all fenced in and everything?
No, there's no fence.
It's just open.
It's open, yeah.
And this is the cemetery right here?
Yeah. Riley even saw it. She's like, Mom, there was a cemetery.
Radio visual brought to you by On the Air with Mike Allen as we describe. let's see if we can go street view here.
Yeah, see if you can, like...
That's on Google Earth. Oh, here's Street View.
But I can't remember the name of it.
Oh, I got Street View.
Okay. Do I have to keep getting up?
No.
I pointed it out. Now you can do the rest.
It's on Jones Street.
I think it was like Taylor. I don't know. I honestly don't remember. Who's dinging? Is that me?
Oh, that's me. That's my phone. Over
oh,
here.
Okay.
Ah, there it is. This is it right here.
Okay. Yes, that is
That's it. And this is the cemetery
yeah,
here.
Okay. So there's one building here.
Uh-huh.
Cemetery and another building.
Ah, yeah. We need to go in there.
And hold on. Turn it again. There's the sign. Taylor. What does that say? Taylor Care something. Keep going. Taylor Care Center.
Taylor Care Center. 212 East Lake Drive.
Yeah. So we're going to have to try to check that out.
It's got...
I don't know how
that's
long.
That's kind of cool.
I don't know how long it's been there. I don't know nothing about it yet.
Dude, and there is. There's an actual cemetery in there.
Yeah.
I'll be down.
Yeah.
Hey, Google Maps is awesome.
We can find anything.
Good deal. All right. So let's try. You got the numbers for that, and I got the numbers for the hotel. We're trying to get in that. So there's lots of stuff going on. If anybody listening right now has something that you want us to go look at, plus I found a bunch of cemeteries, man.
Yes, yes.
I mean, there's just cemeteries all over the place. Just little country cemeteries that are tucked away.
Well, I told you there was those two that I have down that I want to check out.
There's one over there in Hutto, actually, over where those big houses are out east. I can't remember the name of the street.
Oh, over there by...
Over there by where Caesar lives. Yeah, there's a little cemetery right off the...
It's not the Rosalia Cemetery, is it?
No. It's okay. On top of the hill.
Oh, okay.
No. This is just a couple of stones. There's nothing but a couple of stones there. We ought to go down there and sit one night. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Get all scary.
So, hey...
He doesn't believe in ghosts.
Who?
Yeah, I didn't believe until that shit happened. I didn't believe until we went to the
cemetery. Well, you've heard our EVPs and stuff, right? From when we went to Hutto Cemetery.
What?
Even when we went to the sanitarium.
Clueless. Telling you. This is the help I... This is what happens when we have a show and no alcohol.
No, this is what happens when half the people that are on the show don't show up because they're drunk.
Exactly, because they're downtown drunk. With their stupid friends.
So, I took a picture of my house the other night. The kids were playing around.
Uh-huh.
And I actually brought it with me because I wanted to show you the pictures. I thought it was kind of interesting. And you know what the funny thing is the girls were with me, and I asked them, I said, do you see anything different in this picture, in this picture? And they both picked it out. Okay, so here's this picture, okay? Look at this picture. Do you see anything?
This is in your house?
Yeah. You don't see anything, right?
Uh-uh.
Okay. Now, let me show you something.
Some more audio visual.
This is almost the same exact picture.
You're going to post these to your OTA Paranormal page right now?
I'm going
to
show
you. So people can look at what you're looking at?
Now, do you see anything in there?
Oh, my God.
Where am I looking?
Carpet area? Why? If I tell you, you're going to... Okay, look, Mike, whatever. See that?
Yeah.
Okay, same picture, right? Wait.
Huh.
It's not there.
Sure it's a dust speck?
I'm not sure. I don't know. I don't know. And, you know, the good thing is I, you know, I mean, that's why I have a good friend that lives in Australia, because he said send him anything. But look at this one, too. Do you see that?
Huh.
I don't know what it is.
That's no. Weird.
Yeah, so. Like, you know me, I don't throw up. I'll probably send them to William and.
See what he thinks.
See what he thinks, yeah. I, you know, it's always good to have a second or third opinion, you know, third eyes, and especially with the experience that he has under his belt. It's a perfect person.
Oh, absolutely. Here, let me see if I can find that cemetery here on my map feature. Because it's pretty cool. It's just this little dinky cemetery.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Of course, we're all looking at maps that nobody else could see.
I know.
This is great radio. I tell you, this radio, this is the good stuff here, man. This is the good stuff here, man. There's that. And come down here. Okay, there's the road. Okay, it's right. Yeah, there it is. It's not on the map as anything, but you can see the outline of the cemetery. And you can see a couple of the little... stones and stuff right here. And this is just right here close. We could probably go out and set right off the road one night. So we could do that before the skeeters get too bad.
Yeah. We'll let Hutto Police Department know what we're doing. Cause they, you know.
Well, it's not even in city limits, so it doesn't matter. We can do whatever the hell we want. We can get crazy.
We'll do whatever we want.
Get naked.
Okay, no.
Slow down.
Slow down.
What the hell are you talking about? Okay. Oh, man. Well, coming up here in 20 minutes, our own Dani Blaze will be coming on, and we're going to get in bed with her and figure out what she's got going on tonight. It's a good song. Stick around. We'll have some more Heather Bumpus coming back after these messages. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network with some more radio visual coming your way. Promise. Here on the Armed Radio Global Network.
Spirit fingers. Spirit, I got spirit fingers. A shell. This script. Okay.
Cell. 2G. 2000 watts. Yeah.
Hey guys, Dani Blaze here from On the Air with Mike Allen. Tune in every Wednesday night as we explore the nuances of dating and relationships in the modern age, and of course, whatever else turns us on. The show starts at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, and you can get into bed with me, Dani Blaze, at 11 p.m. On the Air with Mike Allen, only on Armed Radio Global.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Sign with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
That's basically it right there. All right, welcome back to the show. Coming up in about 20 minutes, we're getting in bed with Dani Blaze. That's going to be a lot of fun. She's going to talk about, ladies, if you dress like a slut, don't get mad if you get treated like a slut, and other stuff like that. And all from the mind of the very seasoned and very knowledgeable 22-year-old airline stewardess. So there you go. And also, she's going to talk about guys, you know, when you're trying to impress that woman that you're met online, probably sending them a picture of your junk isn't the best way to do it, and the woman's perspective on that. And that's all coming up in 20 minutes as we get in bed with Miss Dani Blaze. So I'm sober. I can't do this show sober. This is bullshit. It's bullshit, Aaron. Hop on it. Come on, Aaron. They abandoned us. It's just me and you now, buddy. You got to hobble your way back over the other side. Just be careful of the wires here. Yeah. DJ Palavowit, what was it?
Badussi.
Badussi. And that stands for?
Butt, dick, and pussy all in one.
Badussi. DJ Badussi. Back on the show. You can check out our webpage, ontheairwithmikeallen.com. It's in progress right now. We're trying to get another webmaster because we fired the last slack hole that was there. Yeah, we're sober. This sucks.
I'm just sorry.
Why are you sorry?
I don't know.
Did you have alcohol that you could have brought and you didn't?
No.
There's no alcohol in the Bumpus household?
Nope.
Will we be drinking Sunday?
No. Well, I mean, you guys can, but me and Johnny won't be.
Well, that's not fun.
Sorry. I think she's turning the air on.
She's turning the air on?
Yeah,
okay.
It's really hot.
I know it's hot. Look at this thing.
I know. So, yeah, just to let everybody know that we're going to just...
play poker and have them take all our money?
No, I wasn't even talking about that. I'm talking about the investigation. We'll get one in there. We just got to find a few places.
His ankle got broken.
All right, talk about JoJo, the new dog?
Yes.
JoJo's right paw, I guess he was abused when he was a puppy and it got broke and then it didn't heal right, so, yeah. So yeah, I had a rough life. He got the shit kicked out of him last week. So,
I'm going to wrap it up and say goodnight.
Good deal.
Because I'm tired.
Well, thanks for stopping by. I hope everything is going well. Give your father my best.
He says thanks for stopping by. Like, I just, you know, happened to just come on in. And, hey, I'll be on the show tonight. You know. Not like I'm not here every week.
Well, I know you got a lot of stuff going on. Yeah, and I know coming over here. And I appreciate it. Because, you know, it's always a pleasure to have you. And give your father our best. And we'll see him Sunday.
Yes, yes. Looking forward to that. Poker. We just got to let him win. No.
Isn't he really good at poker?
Yeah, he's good at poker.
Well, I will borrow $20 from Johnny so that he can just win
so
it back.
So he can just take it back. Well, it's going to be tournament. It's going to be tournament style. So it's going to be you buy in, and then at the end, you know, I think we're going to pay up to three players, depending on how many people we have.
Okay.
So.
Well, I just thought it was kind of funny. The last time I was over there playing poker, of course, I suck. I'm totally horrible at it.
Yeah.
And Johnny's like, why don't I keep playing? Come on, Mike. I said, I got no money. He says, I'll lend you $20. I said, well, I don't want to take your money. He goes, don't worry about it. He won it back like in less than an hour.
Well, you know he's good at poker. I mean, you know.
I know. I just play because I just try to last.
Yeah.
Because I suck at poker. I have no. Johnny I have is no all idea. About. I really don't have any idea what
Johnny
I'm doing.
Johnny is all about strategy and analyzing and counting and
counting
math
and looking at the player. And
yeah.
I just,
yeah.
I just drink and throw my money away. I don't play poker unless I have that money to throw away.
So everybody,
and I count it as a donation.
So everybody that's listening, we're having a tournament at our house Sunday. If you want to come, come on, bring your money.
Yep, go to OTA Paranormal and send Heather a message if you'd like. If you're in the Texas area and around Hutto, you know, we can go have a good time. And I'm going to drink because I can walk there.
Yeah, that's fine. There's going to be people. Chris is going to be there. So I mean, there's going to be people there. Chris is going to be there. You know, you met Chris.
Yeah, I met Chris.
And I think a couple others that you know are going to be there. DJ and Tracy are going to probably be there.
Okay.
So, yeah. I mean, there's going to be
a wander on down.
Yeah.
I met Tracy at the cheer camp.
Yeah, yeah.
And DJ Papalopoulos over here.
No, it's Gimp. Gimp's going to help me all my
stretch. So, yeah. Anybody is anybody's invited. So I'm going home. I'm tired.
All right.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
You want me to leave this?
Heather Bumpus, the OTA paranormal expert for On the Air. And always glad to have her. Are you going to take your headphones?
No, I'll leave them.
Okay.
If you guys need them.
Sure.
So I'll just
go around.
I mean, they'll just get hung up on the thing. And
yeah, that's fine.
You don't use them for anything else, do you?
No, well, Riley's headphones got ate the other night. I think Brisket ate them. So she was using mine, but I'm gonna take her tomorrow and get her a new pair.
Get her a new pair.
Yeah, I go to another the five and below.
Five and below.
That's where I got
them. We ought to try it. Hey, we ought to try
awesome.
That.
No, this is cool.
Dude, these I got for $5, and they are the best headphones I've ever had.
I got these for $20.
Well, mine are better.
Oh, well.
All right, is it my turn?
Yes, it's your turn.
Almost. Annie. 10 minutes.
Oh, let me just start.
10 minutes. Oh, my God.
Yeah, she does have a lot to say. You might as well start. You know her. She always
has. Damn. I'm sleeping like gun under my pillow tonight.
Bye.
That look. See you, Heather.
I give her a round.
Okay, so get us a preview there.
A preview.
Worldly, renowned, 22-year-old, full of knowledge.
I take offense to that because I'm smart and you know it. I said I'm not old.
I didn't say
I'm still
old.
Young and beautiful.
I said worldly.
That means old.
Oh. Does that mean old?
No.
No, it doesn't mean old.
That means old.
Okay, we go to the booth. Old?
You said
yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Oh, no. Gimp is going to look up the definition.
Yeah. No, synonyms.
Jerry's like, why the hell are you dragging me into this crap?
Oh, he'll regret that answer. Just kidding.
She's got tiny little fists, and they hurt like hell.
Sophisticated, experienced, worldly wise,
old,
knowing, enlightened, nothing.
Nothing about old. Thank you.
No, 22-year-old.
I want to apologize. I want an apology.
I'm not gonna
right
apologize. You can SD. I am not apologizing.
I'm gonna write on this card like I'm writing something important.
Right, right. I will wave my hand like I'm.
No, I'm putting it down. Worldly. Another visual. See, we got to be on TV. God, Huggy Bear, let me down.
Whatever. Anyways, I was supposed to be giving a preview.
Yeah, what are we going to be talking about?
Why guys feel the need to send random dick pics to people? One, because no girl ever gets a dick pic and is like, whoa, my day is so much better now. They're like, ugh, gross. Dicks are ugly.
What?
If you're like sexting and you're like with that person and you get a dick pic, it's appropriate in that situation because I'm assuming both are sending nudes. Yeah. But when you wake up and you have a random dick on your phone, you're not going to have a good day.
And where do you mostly get these dick pics from?
Snapchat. I just get like angry. I'm like, what are you shitting on my dick right now? Like, this is not real. I don't want to open a Snapchat and see that. I don't send that in Snapchats.
And so what else? What else do you have going on?
Well, we were talking about like dress code in like high schools or like whatever. Mm-hmm. How they're like, oh, girls need to be conservative and stuff. And I'm like, why don't they just teach 16-year-old boys not to be pieces of shit? But whatever. And then we're also talking about why women dress like very scantily clad and then get mad when they get treated
less than
a lady. Act like a lady.
And what are you wearing right now?
I'm wearing casual.
Casual? This is what we call casual. Okay.
I can go put on some stripper shoes and like
you just go weird. For it?
No, this is like a...
I bet you won't get weird. What?
You said that every time because you know that's going to irritate me and then I'll get weird.
I just bet you won't.
I bet you won't.
Oh, you don't want me to get weird? I'll close this room.
That's fair. Okay. Cut to commercial so we can start my segment.
Well, we got 4 minutes.
I have to sit here and talk. I'm pretty much talking about my segment. I'm pretty much telling my segment. All right.
So you want
to
cut the commercial early?
Yeah. And then we'll just go to the segment? Yes. Thank you.
So you're calling the shots now? Yeah. So you're in charge?
I'm running this.
So you're running things?
I'm spirit fingers.
You know, everybody says you're running things.
That's because I am. Princess Dani Blaze running stuff.
When we get back, we'll get in bed with Dani Blaze. You're listening to On the Air with Mike Allen right here on the Armed Radio Global Network.
Attention, world of tank gamers. Armed and its affiliated divisions are recruiting entire clans and tankers. Armed, the largest and most progressive gaming community on the World of Tanks gaming platform. Now on 3 servers. To join, visit www.armedtanks.net or hashtag need a toaster. Toast that, bitches.
Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern Thursdays is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live.
On Live 365 exclusively
on Armed Radio Global.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Oh yeah, now it's time. Get to your comfortable clothes. Been a long day at work. Kids are in bed, hopefully on the East Coast. If your kids are still up listening to this radio program, well, you're just a bad parent. The views and opinions expressed in this segment of On the Air with Mike Allen as we get in bed with Dani Blaze. The views and opinions of Dani Blaze, DJ Papalot, Papala, Papalock,
Badissi. A.K.A. Gimp.
And do not reflect the views and opinions of me, Armed Radio, Joe Savino, anybody else affiliated with Armed Radio, or the general population, except Matt.
He has the same opinions as me.
Yeah, Matt Haisley. Matt Haisley has the same opinions as a 22-year-old airline stewardess.
Who's Matt Haisley?
He does another segment.
From Straight Talk with Matt Haisley, yeah. All right, here she is. Fresh off her first couple of days, at first week?
3 days.
First 3 days? No, you started work Monday. Oh, it's Wednesday. here she is, Miss Dani Blaze.
Okay, so I guess we already disclosed what I would be talking about. But recently, and by recently I mean today, I received an unwanted and unsolicited dick pic. And I always wondered why guys feel the need to just, like, put it out there. Just like that guy that we talked about last week that said I was a virgin because I didn't want a picture of his dick. Maybe I just don't want to see it. Because no girl wants to see it. No girl's like, oh, man, look at that. I get more turned on looking at a naked lady than looking at a penis.
Hold on, say that again.
No. But for real, like, why apparently no guy in this room has ever sent one, so I guess that's not going to help my case any.
I've sent one.
Will your mouth still remember the taste of these nuts?
I hate you and your soundboards, because it always throws me off. So you sent one. Why? But that was a long-distance relationship. That's different. That's, yeah. Like, wanted.
Yeah.
That's like, hey, we're, like, sexting and...
How would you like to suck my balls?
What did you say?
I'm sorry. Actually, what I said was... How would you like to suck my balls?
Is that kind of what it feels like?
Yeah.
Okay.
Basically.
I'll stop.
Thank you, soundboard master.
What about ball pics? Like, anybody send you a ball pic?
No.
Just a picture of
They're
some
usually
balls?
Just, like, there.
No sack pics?
No, I haven't got, like, just a... Like, balls.
See, one thing that makes me mad is, like...
Like, guys want boob pics and, like, ladybug pics. No girl that I encounter wants random... Let me clarify that. Random penis pictures. It's weird. And then you have to, like, get ready for that picture. So, like, you have to, like...
Well...
Kind of jerk it a little bit to get it going. You can't send a you can't send a picture of a soft dick because that's even weirder.
Yeah, then you have to take like a how when you take selfies. I
like,
guess.
Do you have to angle it right and like do filters and like lighting?
You take like 50 different pictures.
And then pick like the best one.
Yeah, and then you like put it on Instagram and then you delete it so nobody sees it, and then you get the right lighting and then you send it.
That's a process, man. I feel like that's what actually happens, Gimp. Thanks. I can't believe I'll never send them. I appreciate that. Girls out there listening, appreciate that y'all don't do it. No? Okay, cool. Well, whatever.
Well, how do you feel when someone sends you a...
Grossed out! I'm just like, ugh. Thanks
for... There's never been one time you're like, oh, wow, that's a good-looking penis.
Not random ones. Like, if I was like... We're on that discussion and like sexting, maybe, but... No. I have seen, like, one penis in my whole life that I thought was, like, that's not repulsive. But I was also in South Padre and really hammered, so it could have been for all I know. But, yeah, no, it just kind of ruins your day. I'm just like, ugh, now I'm irritated. Thanks. That's why girls don't want to have sex anymore. That's why girls are like, mm-mm, I'm not in the mood. Because we get random shit like that that just irritates us. And then it's all we think about all day. And then they're like, when you try to tell them something, you're like, hey, I'm like, knock your shit off. They're like, why are you mad? I'm like, get out of my face.
So there's guys that actually get offended that you're not
turned on
by their penis pics.
Like, thank you. I didn't ask for it, so what made you think I was going to like it? Like, oh, surprise!
Have you ever had anybody turned on by your underwear?
Oh, God. No, we talked about that guy with the creepy... wrestler guy that does bust.
Well, we weren't fast enough to get a picture of my grundies on there for you.
I'm sure he would have been turned on by that. Freaky freak. Oh my.
I didn't hear this one.
You didn't hear this one?
Back in the day.
Tinder.
Yeah, God. Fuck my life.
So long ago.
So, yeah.
No, like when I first became
about two. It was about 2 months ago.
No.
It was right after the Yes game.
No, it was because I picked that one. That was right after I moved in.
I know,
here.
But it was part of that barrage.
Oh, yeah. No, but that, no, because I had hung out with him before that. Because I had, that's when I first moved in here, after me and Austin broke up.
Okay.
Anyways, so needless to say, this guy stays the night at my house. Then he's like, hey, you should come over one night. And I'm like, no, I'm good, because you're really annoying, and you're just really stupid. And then he proceeded to tell me that when he was over here, he dug in my hamper and then stitched my dirty underwear. Apparently that turns him on.
You can hear that.
Sorry. And then he was like offended that I was like, that's really fucking creepy. Please tell me, have you ever done that?
And then he wanted you to send him more.
Wait, you sent him a picture of your underwear and it turned him on?
No, he was here because we had hung out. And then apparently he informed me that he dug in my hamper and then sniffed my dirty underwear.
Yeah.
Like,
but what the creepiest thing about this thing was, is that he came over here. He didn't have dinner, did he?
No.
He just came over?
We didn't have sex, nothing.
Woke up in the morning, didn't have sex with her.
Nothing.
All night.
Well, I guess
just got up in the morning, and when she got up to do her lady parts things and come have coffee and stuff, and He just stayed in the room and sniffed her underwear. And that was his whole gig. He did.
Maybe that's like in his mind the next best thing. Like, I didn't get laid. Might as well sniff.
No, he didn't try. That's the thing. He didn't even try.
Oh, so he just came over here. Right? Am I right?
Yeah. I'm sniffing panties.
Yeah.
I don't even think we ever kissed. No, and actually, it all started with a dick pic. That's when you and me were at that place in Rockdale eating. And then I was like, who's this? And then all of a sudden, it was a picture of his penis. And I was like, one, I've never even seen your penis, so how would I know that's you?
He sends a message.
It was like a selfie.
He sends a message like, hey, you know, what you doing? And she goes, well, who is this? And the very next thing he answers with is a picture of him holding his junk.
Like a selfie.
So
you still have it?
No, I don't still have it. I had to block his number.
Hey, you
got to
say that stuff. It's hilarious.
I had to block his number. He wouldn't leave me alone.
Guy sends you a dick pic, and then you invite him over.
No. This is like months of not hanging out with him or talking to him.
Yeah. No, he blew it the first night. He blew it the first night.
That, he was just so stupid. God, I couldn't even talk to him because he was so stupid.
So how long was it in between him sending you a dick pic and then you telling him he can come over?
About a good month. No, he didn't come over after the dick pic.
No.
The dick pic was after he'd already come here and sniffed panties. And he wanted a picture of her panties.
Wow.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's like
Tinder. I can't even get a date on Tinder. And she's
this one's good. He hasn't sniffed my panties as far as I know. Don't ever tell me if you did. But do you guys do that? I thought that was like a myth.
I thought you didn't wear panties. Never mind. Never mind.
I have never sniffed panties. I don't think I ever have.
I've always been told like guys do that because it's like the like pheromones and whatever. But like,
I do it in the morning to see what's clean, only because I'm not very.
But you're sniffing your own underwear, not somebody else's.
Kind of find out which. You turn them inside out and let them run another day.
Like, yeah.
What? What do you mean no?
No. Well, I have so much underwear that would last me like a good 6 months before I'd have to actually do laundry. So.
That's true.
Yeah, so
I got like 3 pair of clothes.
That's a lot of panties to be sniffing.
It's like rubbing them all over his body.
Yeah, no. Why would I save that?
Like that guy from DuckTales, it's like swimming in fucking money, but it's panties.
It's Danny's panties that he poured out all over the floor.
Like, one, why would I say that? No,
what's
I had
his fucking name? Scrooge McDuck or not?
Scrooge McDuck, yeah.
I had to actually block him because he would not leave me alone. I had to, like, block his number and, like, block him off of everything.
Oh, that's funny. You should have turned him over to the Finger Bang Gang, man. We had fun with him.
The cock block.
Basically. Anyways.
So guys like that, Danny.
So he got cock blocked by his cock.
You got to turn him over to the Finger Bang Gang because we can have fun with that guy.
You did. You were doing most of the texting.
Oh, that's true.
We were at dinner texting this person that then...
In Thorndale.
Oh, that food's so good.
Oh, my God. Could you be taking him out there yet?
No. We've been only... I can't stop. It's like a thing.
I know. Don't. Because it
comes out of
it.
Okay, anyways. Now we're done talking about my really sad life.
Are we?
No.
Not really?
No, so we...
I know, we got two more segments.
Next week, we'll definitely have...
We got to get Jerry in here.
Oh, yeah. God. Oh, God. But this doesn't scare him off. He can stay. Anyways, so...
It's all part of the vetting process.
We're just toughening you up. None of this is true. I wish. So we were talking about dress codes and stuff, and, like, especially in high school, why they're, like, so strict with how women dress. They have to be very... No cleavage, no belly button, no... Your knees have to be Amish level.
Very, very Taliban.
Yeah.
Your knees don't get to touch your elbows.
Right? Your knees can't touch your elbows.
Yeah. Or your knees can't touch your ears, either.
Oh, I see where you're going.
Yeah. No, so I was always wondering...
Then you have,
like,
to go to the alternative school.
I'm like, well, one, it's Texas, and I'm tall, so I don't feel like I should have to wear pants every day because I can't find shorts that are going to be long enough to where you feel like it's an appropriate level for me not to turn on men. But why wouldn't they just, like, teach guys to be like, hey, just because she has, like... Obviously, I'm not going to go to school in, like, a skimpy going-to-the-club dress. Like, why can't I just wear, like, shorts and, like, a t-shirt? You know?
Yeah.
But I feel like...
But would you if you could?
No! One, schools are too cold. I'd be cold the whole time. I'd just be miserable. But, like, I don't understand why they don't teach guys to keep it together.
They do. What are you talking about? Like, they tell us all the time, like...
Just, no means no.
Yeah, no means no, all that stuff. What are you talking about?
No! Why should I have to cover my body because I'm around hormonal men?
Because they're hormonal men.
Because they're hormonal men.
Yeah, you're talking about...
So why does that affect... Why does that affect me?
You're thinking about 16, 15-year-olds that are just... That can only think with their penis.
So I have to wear lesbian Bermuda shorts because...
Not lesbian Bermuda shorts.
No, I look like a lesbian in them. I have short hair. Come on now. I heard that. So you can take pictures, but I can't click a pen?
Nope.
Whatever. But, anyways, I don't feel like I should have to cover my body so that way I don't... They're like, it's for your safety. Like, what am I going to get into a gangbang if I wear shorts? Like, that's not fair.
Well, but, is it fair to show skin and dress like a pop star when young men who can't control their hormones are trying to study and trying to get things done? And, you know, here comes...
So because you
here
can't
comes,
think
Here comes with, Tiffany bouncing down the hallway, barely wearing anything. I mean, that's... You don't think...
No, I feel like you should
so
dress
all the
with,
guys
like
have
should,
to suffer and learn how to handle it and no, get yeah. taught better? And what the hell?
No, I feel like, you should be covered, but geez, like the rules are, like, ridiculous. Like, you got to be, like, 2 inches above your knees, and you better not have any cleavage. I don't really have any cleavage, so I never really had to worry about that. But why can't I wear a tank top and shorts like I normally would?
I mean, would it be better to have, like, a Catholic schoolgirl outfit? Than
no, that would be worse. For y'all, that would be better. Let's, like, go to the internet for that. I can't go to the internet and have free dress. Like, that's not, like, a thing. You guys can go and watch all your sexy fantasies online. But at the same time, I don't feel... Why is that fair? So, I have to be uncomfortable and sweaty and hot because you might get turned on because my thighs are showing.
Yes.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
That's such crap. That's such crap.
Well, just be glad we're not the Taliban and you have to go full burqa.
Yeah. Oh, God, no.
I mean, every gender has a... Certain expectations, I guess. I don't know what you want to say to that.
I mean, would it be appropriate for guys in high school, athletes, good-looking guys, to walk around in really tight T-shirts and tight pants? And
yes.
Not and maybe not even not the like the good-looking guys.
Right? Guys like me.
Yeah.
If that's what you want to wear.
I've seen some fat girls wearing some stuff that it's like
8 sizes too small.
Yes.
I'm like, you look like a busted can of biscuits. That's not cute. Smaller clothes don't make you smaller. Dress your body. Dress the body you have, not the body you think you have.
Yeah.
No, but on the other side, like...
So...
Let's say we're going out.
Okay.
We're going downtown. We're hunting. So obviously, we're going to have, like, stripper heels on.
Tight skirts.
Everything's going to be barely hanging on. It's going to be, like, threaded, like we breathe too deep and everything will be exposed.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't understand why women dress like that and then get mad. Like, you're literally barely covering it. You're pretty much wearing pasties and a skirt downtown, let's mm-hmm. say. But then you're going to get mad that guys are like...
Looking at him.
Hey, look at you. And
how you doing?
Your butt looks nice in that skirt. When they know damn well they put that on for that exact reason.
I'd love to see your skirt bunched up at the bottom of my bed.
I mean, like, I feel like some of the stuff that they say is a little extreme, but I feel like if you're going to dress like that...
What's the worst line you've ever had, that you've ever heard?
Oh, God.
What's the best line you've ever heard?
What's the best one? What's the one that swept you off your feet and it's like, this guy, I'm going home with this guy? Oh, just the line.
Nothing.
Nothing?
Mm-mm.
What line did you use, Jerry?
He wasn't an asshole. He didn't use a line. Well, actually, he was like, do you want to take a ride on my motorcycle? And that was pretty much it. So
that that's it. Oh, that's the best. That's the line.
That may have
right
been
there.
The line.
Hell, that line had worked for me. Found a motorcycle.
Yeah.
No, he just wasn't an asshole.
All right, what's the worst line?
I don't even know.
What was the one line where you looked at the guy and you're like, really?
Oh, the stuff that Aaron sends me?
What are some of the ones that...
The cool thing about Sir Gimsalot over here is that he says the most outlandish stuff to girls, like messing with them, and they totally buy into it.
What's the most outlandish thing you said to a girl that you went home with and had relations?
Probably the jalapenos line.
What's that?
I went up to her and I was like, hey, do you like jalapenos? And she was like, I love jalapenos. You know, I love Mexican food, I love spicy food. And I was like... Good, because I'm going to be jalapeno your pussy in a little bit.
And it works. I witnessed this with my own eyes.
And it worked.
That and the pet insurance one.
It worked.
It worked.
And you went home.
Yeah, like.
Okay, pet insurance. Go ahead.
Yeah, I was sniffing panties all night.
That's the pet insurance?
No.
No. You haven't heard the pet insurance?
No.
That's my favorite one. I don't think I've used it yet. I do it jokingly, but it's you can just go up to a woman and say, "Hey, I don't mean to be rude, but do you have a pet insurance?" And she'll say, "Oh, yes, I have a cat," or "No, I don't have any pets," or anything. And I was like, "Okay, good. Because I'm going to smash that pussy."
But he says this crazy shit. It works.
Work.
They have worked from time to time.
Give me another one.
Oh, fuck. Put me on a spot. Give me a second.
Pretend like you're messaging people on Tinder.
Oh, yeah, the Weatherman one. The Weatherman is, it says, I say, "I'm no Weatherman, but I think you can expect more than a few inches tonight."
I think you've sent that one to me, too.
Yeah, I did send that to you.
But they work. I don't get it. The same as just how Danger Davis and Mad Mike get laid. I just can't comprehend it.
And here I sit.
I don't think Davis gets laid as much as he says.
No.
Well, here's the thing about... is it Davis or is it Patrick in here?
No, Danger Patrick. Davis is...
Danger Davis is Patrick.
Danger Davis. The thing about Danger Davis is that, like, he... Yeah, I guess he does have sex with chicks, but he's, like, hooking up with chicks who, like, wipe from back to front. You know what I mean? Like, nasty bitches. Like...
infections?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's why his beard smells...
That whole yeast infection thing was...
Yeah. Yeah, like, you know... Chicks whose panties smell like sourdough. You know what I mean? Like, that's who he's hooking up with.
They're definitely not quality women.
Yeah.
And some of them are strippers. No offense.
Well, strippers aren't bad. Some of them.
Yeah.
They just hate men.
Because they're exploiting themselves, and then they're being mad at the men for it.
Pretty much. They have daddy issues.
That's fair.
I'll be back with more Dani Blaze. Sober. First sober show ever. Tonight.
That's a lie.
We've never done this show sober. Not at this point. At this point, we've always been pretty lubed up. All right, we'll be back. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you're on the air.
I like better when Danger Davis is here.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365 exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV.
Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Cell 2G 2000 watts. Yeah, yeah.
Never meant taking in my
bedroom. Oh, shenanigans. I mean, at this point, what are we even talking about
welcome
now?
Back.
Yeah, welcome back. It's Dani Blaze. We're talking about you gotta write this out for me. We do this every Wednesday.
I know. That's why you should have it memorized by now.
No. I just start talking. You know, we got time for small
welcome
talk.
Back. You're in bed with Dani Blaze.
I don't. What do you want me to
welcome
say?
Welcome back. You're in bed with Dani Blaze.
You are literally saying it. So why do I need to say it?
Here she is, the chick.
Thank you. Well, that escalated from women dressing
who's
like...
Who's our sponsor tonight?
E24.com.
And how do you get a hold of E24.com?
Download the app.
And then what do you do with the app?
You use it.
How?
You put in your zip code, and then they tell you where you can order food from. And you get delivered.
Right to you.
Unless you live in Haddo.
It's also brought to us by Patrick's Cleaners.
Oh my god!
Oh,
that's right,
Patrick's Cleaners!
Starch in your socks one sock at a time.
Patrick's Cleaners. We're going to get t-shirts and everything with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we totally forgot about that.
No, we totally dropped the ball.
So we went from women dressing like sluts and being mad that they got treated like sluts to pickup lines.
Pickup lines were great. You got any more?
Should talk about the chick from last night.
Oh, yes, I'll talk about that girl. Jeez, that was a train wreck if I ever saw one. I don't even remember her name. So we went to midget wrestling last night, which was super fun, by the way.
They're good, aren't they?
It was like they put on a show. There was one that was rapping. It was awesome. It was a rapping wrestling midget. It was dope. His name was Too Tall.
Nice.
It was great. Anyway, so at the intermission, they had what was called midget grinding. So like four women from... the audience got into the ring. They each had, like, their own corner. And then they took turns dry humping a midget. Well, the first girl went. She was kind of boring. Second girl went. She was actually pretty good. Third girl went. It was really awkward, and I felt uncomfortable. And then the fourth girl went. And apparently, I actually went to high school with this girl.
You can't remember her name?
I can't to save my life. I mean, she looks like a train wreck now. I mean, she has, like... she was in, like, this, like, skimpy, like, low-cut... tight dress, like her butt cheeks are hanging out. It was like a hot mess, and she looked like she's been ran over.
So my kind of girl.
She looked like she's been ran over and hung up to dry
One of Patrick's girls.
One of Daniel Davis's girls. Like, she definitely does drugs. So anyway, so she goes. As she's grinding on this midget, we all become aware that she is not wearing any underwear. I saw her ladybug.
The whole thing?
Also unsolicited. Yeah. Oh, no, like, it was all just, it's like a 3D movie. I felt like it was coming at me. And then, because she's like a, you know those, like, halter tops that are, like, kind of floaty right here and, like, shows a lot of boob? That's how the top of her dress was. And, like, all of a sudden it's, like, moving. I was like, boob, boob, boob. And then her whole boob popped out. Her whole entire boob popped out.
Was it nice?
Was it nice? Yeah.
I mean, it's not the worst boob I've ever seen, but it was just, like, I was more in shock that, like, her boob just popped out.
And she didn't care.
No,
she kept,
like,
on going.
Yeah. I mean, like, I don't think she realized for a second until people were like, hey, like, you got your boob out. And then she's like, ah.
So boobs are out. Meat curtains are flapping. Didn't care.
No. It was like an old.
Now, was it a ladybug or more like a dung beetle?
I mean, maybe. At that point, probably. Based on her actions, I mean,
was it a grasshopper, maybe?
I could only assume.
What are you referring to when you say
ladybug?
Yeah.
Her Hassan Pfeffer.
Her
vagina.
Oh, the
her spit split.
It's the toothless hair shark, just so you know. That's my favorite description right there.
That's why we love having DJ Padunkadunk on here, because...
Oh my, okay, so why is it called that?
Well, it's
the pink crotch vacuum.
Why is it called a toothless hair shark? Yeah. Well, it doesn't have any teeth.
Okay.
Toothless.
And it eats like a shark. And it has hair.
I don't know if I should be like offended by that or complimented by that. That people refer to.
You know what? I'm going to look it up and see whether.
Okay, you Google about that.
To the intranets.
Anyways, I don't think it
was
the
toothless hair shark. I gotta get on.
I don't think it was the finest china around. It was probably more like a paper plate type of deal at that point. So you wouldn't hang it up and show your parents when
was
they
it
came.
Was it an innie or an outie?
It was just kind of like all there.
There's an actual animal called the toothless megamouth shark.
Oh, God.
Toothless hair shark,
this is
right?
What happens to me? Is that a thing?
Toothless hair shark.
Is that
it's
real?
It's a picture they have. Look at, is this what it looked like?
Yes. Oh, my God.
Yeah, that is.
Did you see it, Jerry?
No, he didn't even realize what was going on. He didn't pay attention until the boob popped out. But yeah, that's kind of an accurate description.
It's like talking to us. That's what it looks like.
Toothless hair shark. I'll be goddamn.
Yeah.
Google.
So, again, she looks like she's had a rough go since high school, so. Or maybe she's had a really great go. I don't know. She looks like she'd probably have a pimp.
Really?
I mean, she.
Kind of like our friend online that doesn't smile.
Oh, gosh. I forgot about
that
lady.
Is that just so sad?
I mean, when I couldn't stop looking.
I know.
I have to show you.
You just
that.
Have to. You just have. You just clicking through her pictures and.
This is a train wreck. Yeah, that's what she. It's like a younger version of that, which is sadder because she's. Like,
well,
my
she's
age.
Your age. Yeah.
So I gotta see free boobs at midget wrestling last night. I gotta see a free boob. Didn't even get both of them, bitch. Like, if you're gonna put it out there, put it out
there.
Yeah,
you might as well.
I mean, you already showed your vagina. What's the boobs gonna hurt?
Flapping around the interior decorating.
Hmm.
Was everybody excited when a boob popped out?
Yeah.
Oh, that place
of course.
Did it really? Yeah. Then it was on purpose. I'm sure she reveled in the attention that she was getting.
Oh, yeah, because even after, she was, like, still dancing.
It's
even
like,
after.
Oh, my
over.
God, I can't believe my boobs. Like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, oops. Oh, my panties. Oh, I didn't wear any. Oh, my God.
Yeah. It was like that, but, like, drunk and slutty.
Nice. You think she went home with one of the midgets?
She went home with somebody, I'm assuming.
She went home with two midgets on top of each other to, like, make one person.
Tag team.
Yeah.
Nice.
Two for one special. Buy one, get one free.
So would that be like a mini split roast?
Yeah.
You should have been there.
I'm just asking.
But they have to be on top of each other at all times.
Yeah. I feel like mathematically that wouldn't work out too well. If they stayed on top of each other the whole time? To like, how'd you then do things? Is she like...
Let's Google it.
Is she like double-deckering? Like,
I'm pretty sure that's on YouTube somewhere, right? Or not YouTube. X-Video?
Did I ever tell you my idea for a restaurant where it's for nothing but midgets?
That work there or can only go there?
Only midgets can go eat there.
Only midgets can go eat?
Yeah.
That's messed up.
Yeah.
What's it called? Strawberry shortcakes?
No, I came up with a name, but I can't think of it. It had to do something with, like... I can't think of the name right now. But let me explain it. So why are you telling us this?
Oh, okay, go ahead.
So it's all like miniature items. And you're only serving them like kids' meal, but you charge them full price. Because otherwise it's fucked up if you charge them full, like half price. You can't just charge them into half price. That's fucked up.
Yeah, well, that's oppression.
Yeah. So like, let's say you have like a booth of 8. You could say 16 midgets in there. You know, you could fit so many midgets in a booth.
And then you charge them full price, you make twice as much money.
And then, like, we would have, like, the roof.
For half the work.
Yeah. And then you would have, like, the roof maybe really low so that they feel like normal people when they walk in. Because they're like, oh, my God, I'm so tall in this place.
So then would midgets have to serve them? Because then...
No, we would have the tallest, like, 6'8" servers.
So, like, bent down?
Pretty much. They're all bent down and just serving them, like, kids' meals.
But if you put the kids' meals on a smaller plate, it would look like a full meal, so they wouldn't even realize that they were being charged. Kids.
Yeah, but you charge them full price.
Now, plastic flatware or real flatware?
I mean, do midgets eat silverware?
No, but would you use, like, for little kids, or would you have
no kids in that. It's all midgets.
It's all grown-ups, grown-up midgets.
Yeah, it's just grown-up midgets.
What was the name of it?
I'm going to get a text at 2 in the morning.
I think it was Uncle Phil's Taco Mini Bar.
Uncle Phil's Taco.
Yeah, Taco and Mini Bar.
And Mini Bar.
Yeah.
Now, would you have the mini bottles of alcohol for the midgets? Yes,
but charge full price.
Then they can feel accepted because they're paying full price.
Yeah, they're paying, you know, regular people money.
Yeah. Not midget money.
They're playing that tall money.
The views and opinions expressed on this program do not reflect Uncle Phil's
Taco and Mini Bar.
Taco and Mini Bar.
Or Uncle Phil's Happy Good Times. I don't know.
But why Uncle Phil?
I don't know, because it sounds really...
Uncle Phil's Yellow Brick Road.
That's racist.
Yeah, that's
why is that racist?
That's mean.
Yeah.
Why is it racist?
I don't know. It's not racist, but it's...
It's from The Wizard of Oz.
Midgetist.
You're being a real midgetist. What was it on chart?
You're being a really tall person right now.
Yeah. You're being too tall.
Your tall privilege.
Oh, let me talk about that.
Like tall privilege.
Not tall privilege, but skinny privilege. Because I have a rant about that. Apparently.
Skinny privilege?
Yeah, last time I went to go see my dad in July.
Okay, well, we're going to hold that rant. Okay. Yeah, for the last segment, because you're about ready to go off.
Oh yeah, mom's.
I can see you got crazy eyes.
Ah.
If you ever see these eyes, run. That's why I have a door right there. All right, we'll be back. Last segment.
Huh?
What is that?
What?
That music. That's awful.
Yeah, he only plays shitty music. It's like he wants to make it.
We'll be right back. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air. Ever have a computer issue that you can't figure out? Is your computer running slow, locking up, or giving you the blue screen of death? Now you have a store that not only can diagnose your rig, but if needed, upgrade that tired old workhorse. Centex Computers in Hutto is equipped not only to fix your computer, but give you an honest analysis of what needs to be fixed. Let's face it, your home computer is not only convenient, it's essential for your home or your office to stay in touch in this new virtual world. Now you have a place to take your computer for honest and reliable service. Visit www.centexcomputers.com for locations and times. Centex Computers Hutto is the official computer experts for On the Air with Mike Allen.
Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Night Talk with J Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern Thursdays is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live.
On Live 365 exclusively
on Armed Radio Global.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom. Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern. On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Cell 2G, 2000 watts. Yeah.
Never meant taking in my bedroom. So, girl, please.
Are you going solo? Go ahead.
What was I saying? Welcome back. This is Dani Blaze. Something like that. I wish they could see like the faces I make, because then I feel like they'd forgive me for myself.
Brought to you by.
Oh, brought to you by e24.com.
And
DJ Badusi.
Nope.
Oh, we changed your name.
Patrick's.
Oh, and Patrick's dry cleaning.
Patrick.
Starching your socks one sock at a time.
One sock at a time.
Hmm. What's a creepy noise?
That was a door.
That's not like a creaky door. I don't know. Anyways, if you need your sock starch, call Patrick. So what are we even talking about anymore?
You were talking about male privilege or something?
Oh, thin privilege.
It would be rude not to eat her pie, which I assume is not only hot, but also moist.
You play that one every show.
Yeah, I don't have that many.
But you love that one.
Please, Gary, I'm not from Hollywood. I'm not going to fuck your mouth, and my time is extremely valuable.
That sounds like shit that you say. Oh, yeah, I want to talk about thin privilege.
This thing got really vulgar. Like, remember you used to tell me not to curse?
Well, this is the last hour. And I mean, you don't say it every other word. If one or two slips out, I don't, you know.
Oh, okay.
But we're not talking like Italians here, okay?
Well, yeah, okay.
Anyways, I want to talk about thin privilege, which I'm still not 100% sure what that technically is. But when I was in Utah with my dad, who was like me, but like meaner, we looked up thin privilege because we're like, that's a crock of shit. Just because you're fat doesn't mean I should have to be nice to you. I'm sorry.
Hold on. Let's look up thin privilege.
Yeah. It's like people that are skinny are better off in life and they get more nice things and pretty much skinny people are oppressing fat people. Because I'm thin, I think I'm better than everybody. We need to stop body shaming fat people.
Messed up stuff thin people say. I earned my thin privilege by working out, eating healthy, and taking care of my body. Listen, asshat, the point of privilege is that it is never earned. That's the rule. Class privilege, white privilege, whatever privilege, it's never earned. I don't care how many hours you spend at the gym, how many carrots you eat, or how much cake you turn down. Thin privilege is just like any other privilege. It is never, ever earned.
So, because I have good genes and I'm just naturally thin, I have to... Fat people can be mean to me? Because they're fat and instead of doing something about it, they want to eat.
I'm just reading what I'm finding on the internet.
Yeah, well, this is why I'm mad about it, because it's stupid. So just because you don't want to get off your fat ass and stop eating Twinkies, you have to be mean to me? Because I can eat whatever I want? Sucks to suck, dude. Blame your parents, not me.
Here's a story from a young lady who visited New York. Several years ago, I went to a trip to New York City. It was my first time in the big city, and I was very excited. One of the things I wanted to do was go to a certain famous bakery. You know, she wants to be a pastry chef. And have one of their famous European-style pasticcinis. Pasticcini are bite-sized Italian pastries, and you usually sample a variety of them. When I went to the bakery, I ordered a dozen assorted pastries and a coffee, intending to eat there, because they have a seating area. The cashier glared at me when I paid for my order, then asked me, where's the rest of my group? I said I was alone. She said I asked if I made the mistake of my order, because no one eats a dozen cakes alone. I was mortified and pointed out that the pasticcini, hopefully I'm saying that right, are not cakes. They are one, maybe two bites each. The cashier sneered at me, and she says, whatever, fatty.
Okay, I feel like that's probably traumatized.
I got very angry and asked to see the manager. The cashier called the manager, but then told him that I was being belligerent and that I threatened her. When I denied this and told him what really happened, the manager told me to leave and threatened to call the police.
Thin privilege. Hashtag thin privilege.
As I was leaving, I heard the cashier tell the manager, you know fat people can't control themselves around cake. And they both laughed. Fighting back the tears, I went back to my hotel room. Did she take the cakes with her?
Uh-huh. Yeah, she did. She ate the whole thing. That fucking guy, she's right? So fucking depressed. Yeah,
totally ruined her trip.
So then she binge ate and then ended up on my 600-pound life. So I'm sad. Yeah.
That sounds like a fat girl just making shit up, honestly.
I feel like she dramatized that a little bit. Like, what does she look like? I bet she wears skinny jeans. Skinny jeans don't make you skinny, by the way. I'm angry about this because why do you get to call me anorexic and tell me I need to eat more, but I can't tell you you need to eat less? I'm supposed to embrace that you're fat. Just
well, if you ever told me to eat less, I'd look at you and tell you, fuck.
Yeah. Okay.
What I want.
So I have to accept.
I like to eat.
I have to accept that you love your body. But
well, I don't.
Not you.
I could lose a few.
I'm talking about everyone. Your body's not made to be fat like that. It's not. I understand there's different body types, but you're not made to be 600 pounds for sure.
Here's another tweet. Oh, maybe you should take the fact that you're so heavily obese that you're even above the definition of plus size and use that as a wake-up call.
Yes.
The reply. Maybe you should take the fact that you're so worried about my body that when you took time out of your goddamn day to try to shame me is a wake-up call, and that your life is ruled by your insecurities. There's a lot of F-bombs in here.
Oh.
F-ing-curities. Maybe you should shut the F up and take an effing look at your goddamn privilege, because guess what? Effing what? My body ain't changing. The only people my body bothers is biggest like you and your stupid ass self, and that's your effing problem, not mine. If shit doesn't fit me, I go naked, and I'll enjoy it thoroughly, because I love making pieces of my body policing ass like you I love making pieces of body policing shit like you uncomfortable. I effing live for it. So take this as a wake-up call, sweetheart. My fat ass is coming through, and I ain't moving out of the way for you. So you can either educate yourself or you can get hip-checked into the gutter.
Okay, you want to know the funny thing? Okay, that's great. I love the way she wrote that. But you want to know the funny thing about that is she's not actually comfortable with her body. She's just like she's using it as a defense mechanism. So instead of actually
dealing with that's DaniBlaze at gmail.com.
Yeah. No, yeah. Email me. No, the thing is she's using that as a crutch. Instead of actually dealing with the problem and actually either being comfortable with her body or changing it, she is going to now use it against it. She's just being defensive.
Okay, we started out the show talking about black oppression.
Yeah, right? Well, now I'm talking about skinny people oppression because...
You do realize that fat oppression is real oppression, right? And this is the reply. No, just no. I'm fat. I'm not oppressed. People are assholes. If someone is a bitch to you, it's because they are a bitch. It's not because you are fat. It's because people in society are generally shitty. Fat people can get married. Fat people can have not had to fight for... Fat people have not had to fight for equal rights. Fat people have never been enslaved by skinny people.
They need to be enslaved.
Fat people can own homes, pay taxes, have children, and they are allowed to have jobs and have their own money.
They work very easy.
They are allowed to go anywhere they want. They aren't limited to living in an area for fat people. They have not been systematically picked off and murdered by a body of government.
That's like the female version of you.
What?
That sounds like stuff you say.
Yeah, it's pretty much. These thin, privileged people hide behind their weight as an excuse for their shitty, self-righteous personalities and are so unhappy for whatever reason that they exaggerate online for attention from people they don't even know. This is why you don't hear about thin privilege on anywhere except Tumblr.
That's true. Oh,
it's not real.
It's not real. It's not a thing.
Okay, thinny.
Oh, my gosh. I know.
Okay, toothpick legs.
And everyone's like, okay, so I know there's been like, I think Calvin Klein just went through it. They said that the models were too thin and that's putting a bad image to women and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, so you're saying it's okay to be a 5'6", 24-year-old woman that's 400 pounds, but a model that is probably like me that can't gain weight, we're just thin, that's not okay.
Well,
so I also hate that real men love curves and no, only dogs like bones and blah, blah.
It says here, you can have thin privilege too. Just put down the Big Mac.
Boom. Get off your ass and do something about it. Stop crying about being fat. If you're so mad about being fat, people make fun of you, do something about it.
Well, there's a difference between curves and then humongous blobs of fat that hang over everything. And
I don't want to see it.
No, me neither. How about you?
No, never mind. I was going
to
say something.
I'm not going to blatantly like walk up to somebody and be like, hey, you fat piece of shit.
DJ Papalapa, do you have anything to...
All right, what up, Gimp?
Well, no, I just think it's funny. Like, these chicks talk about, oh, like, I'm curvy and all this stuff. But I'm like, no, you're kind of big. You're a little big. And then, like, those are the same people that are, like, posting, like, pics of, like, Channing Tatum shirtless. And I'm just kind of like, so you want your dude to look like that, but you want to look like a fucking whale. Like, what the fuck?
Gimp used to be fat. I didn't believe
it. Well, you know, sometimes there's guys that like that, though.
I earned my thin privilege.
Yeah. He used to be fat.
I've seen pictures, man.
He got off his ass and he did something about it. Instead of bitching about it, he did something about it.
You know what someone said, though, right, that made me do it? Somebody, like, my ex-girlfriend told me I was fat. So I was like, all right, I'm going to do something about it. Yeah. Not fucking eat a...
Not go binge eat on Twinkies and ice cream.
I lost a lot of weight when
although that's delicious.
Yes, I love Twinkies.
I lost a lot of weight when I was a downtown cop, and I got the lightest I've been in years. I got down to 230 at the time I was married, and then the woman that I was married to told me those three little words that convinced me I needed to lose weight.
What was the three words?
I can't breathe.
No, but like he was saying, like someone said he was fat, so he's like, hey, I'm gonna do something about it. I used to get bullied for being unfortunate looking, and my mom told me, are you going to keep crying about it? Are you going to do something about it? So then I got hot. That's how you do it. You don't cry about it. You don't sit behind your computer and be mean to skinny people because you're sad that you're fat and people make fun of you. People are going to always make fun of you.
Always.
It's not thin privilege. You're just not taking care of yourself, and we're not. I don't feel like I have to accept that.
I wouldn't.
I don't have to. I don't feel like I have to accept the fact that you want to wear a size 2, knowing damn well you're a size 18, squeezing in that with your muffin tops.
Preach it, girl.
Preach it. I don't want to see your stretch marks hanging out everywhere.
Throw down that salad.
No. How often do you see me eat salad? Let's be honest.
You're the crappiest skinny person eater I've ever seen. Yeah. To be quite honest with you.
Thin privilege. I know. I don't. Whatever. Like, I'm not healthy just because I'm thin. Have you ever seen me walk up a flight of stairs? No, because I'm taking the elevator because I'm really out of shape. So.
I can't even go up the stairs right now.
Well, that's because you're gimpy. I don't know. I'm not gonna just walk up to somebody and be like.
Because
like
your chick blew your knee out. Now, what is that story anyway? I heard you guys talking about it. Tell us the story.
Tell us why you're gimpy.
The kicking game for UT
is
now.
Before I have a bunch of fat, angry women show up in the house.
Yeah, if you're fat and angry, 1-866-225-5401 or 512-539-0357.
Any theory you think you have.
Or 512-FAT-FUCK.
Now you're just saying it because I said you could say
yeah.
You just,
yeah. Yeah, I can just curse now, so it's fine. So I was outside on my birthday, outside of a bar. I'm not even drunk. I'm totally sober because I was like, I'm going to go out tomorrow because it's my birthday and I'm going to have a good time. I'm literally just talking to my friend. I'm outside the bar. And then, like, these two fat girls, like, were like, fuck your thin privilege, and just, like, and ran my knee over.
Fuck you for being in shape.
Yeah, and dislocated my knee, and then I tore a ligament in it. So right now I can't do anything. This is the only time I've been out of the house in the past week. Wait, no, two other times, but yeah. Like, all I do is sit at home and, like...
Play video games?
Pretty much. I've played a shitload of Grand Theft Auto. A lot of Netflix.
So at what point in Grand Theft Auto, you've obviously made it all the way through the end of the game, right?
Yeah, I beat it 100% 2 years ago.
So you just go back and just do crazy stuff and
well,
go
you
in
just
doorways
start the game all over again.
Do you ever just go on a map and say, man, I wonder what's over here in this building? Just kind of walk through doors and go upstairs. And
I just have sex with the prostitutes, kill them, and get my money back.
Yeah. Yeah.
You have sex with prostitutes?
Yeah, you can pick up prostitutes, like honk your horn, they'll get in the car, you go have sex with them in some alley, and then they get out, and then you just run them over, and then they drop the money that you just give them, so you just get your money back, and that's it.
Sometimes you can get more money.
Yeah. And then you
just do stupid stuff, get the cops called on you, and then try to beat the cops before they arrest you.
Yeah. It also improves your health. If you like get a prostitute and you get laid, it improves your health.
Sex releases endorphins.
On a video game.
Oh, well, not duh, but hey, I mean, technically that's correct. Oh, sorry. We're supposed to be anti-masturbators.
That's right.
Stop masturbating.
We gotta get them back on the show.
They were great. They were phenomenal.
Awesome. We're about due too. About every 6 months, I can get them on. I always share their posts.
Do you follow them on Facebook?
Yeah.
I love that stuff.
These guys are great. They're great.
What was it? Princess Salami or something? No, that was a different
Salome.
Oh, yeah.
No, it was Salome.
Yeah, no, but I kept calling her Salami because I was drunk.
So, when you pet your lady, but she was coming up with every single different way of talking about female masturbation. Was it pet your ladybug?
I don't know.
Punch the guy in the canoe.
Air out the curtains.
Air out the curtains.
Double click the mouse.
Double click the mouse. It was hilarious. It was awesome. And they were playing it totally straight. It was awesome. It was a good show.
I remember I couldn't say salami when I was drunk. I kept calling her salami. I was like, Princess Salami.
She kept it. Oh, my God. All right. Well, this is our show without alcohol. This will never happen again.
Which is definitely not that much different than our show with alcohol.
No, it's...
Except I was angry at the end.
No, this is pretty slow tonight.
I
was kind of pissed off because that guy was going to come on and I didn't get to work my magic, so...
That would have been good.
I had about a good interview.
What guy?
He's too busy being a feminist, though.
He wrote an article about white privilege and how we don't understand what's happening in Baltimore because we're white and we just need to shut up because we'll never be oppressed and we'll never be
this.
We
shouldn't tell people that they can't riot because they're angry.
There's no brown privilege.
We should understand why...
Except nice tans.
But anyway, it was just reading it. It was funny. And yeah. He wouldn't come on.
We make good salsa.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, you do. Make good food.
Oh, dude, I got to tell. If anybody is in or around the area of Manor, Texas, between 5 in the morning and noon, there's a red food truck that's at the right downtown Manor. It's on the intersection there of...
Manor has a downtown.
673.
How do I have a downtown?
675 or whatever that. Anyway, I got 2 tacos and a soda today for $5, and I had to eat the other taco for lunch. That's how big they were.
Nice.
They were amazing. It was amazing. Absolutely amazing. So if you're down there and you got $5.
Yeah.
Definitely get one of those Earl's Taco Shack. So. All right, well, let's just close this thing down.
Yeah,
I'm sober.
Yeah, me too.
Sucks, man.
I haven't had liquor in a week.
What is wrong with us? Next week we'll have liquor. Next week we will have liquor. Thanks to Rebecca Paddock for joining me tonight. Also, a big thanks to Heather Bumpus and her guest, William Tabone of the Australian Paranormal Association. We'll have him back on and have some more adventures with him. Our audience of 1, Jerry, 4, DJ Poplock, a.k.a. Gimp, Dani Blaze, and Heather Bumpus. I'm Mike Allen. You've been listening to On the Air every Wednesday night, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, right here on Armed Radio Global. See you next week.